probably be putting quite a bit away in the bank, right? You have a lot of Oracles.
I do. No, believe me, I do. So I've got Food Me Twice and Apophenia overlay. Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
To give me an extra bit of sensitivity and scavenging.
Yeah, yeah.
That's two gold, right?
Yep. Gray. I got something for you to spend your money on. If you want, I will give you a bayonet mount to your rifle. If you want to buy a knife, you can have a bayonet.
Nice. You need to have melee for that.
Yes, he will.
I do have melee, don't I?
Specifically need spear fighting, so it'll cost you some money. Yeah, you'll have to buy a skill point for that. But yeah, you'll give you a melee, so you'll have something other than just your big fuck off rifle to use if you get into a scrape.
I then put one point into research. I had none before, I now have research. So
that's
if
correct.
I need to research something,
yep.
I can do it. That leaves me now with nine.
A knife will cost you one upkeep. Well, it cost you two, Gray, because it's we're after start game. So
yeah.
Knife will cost you two upkeep, and then the bayonet mount will cost you one, and then the spear skill point will cost you one. So it'll be four bounty total. But yeah, you can have a bayonet.
So and you haven't put anything in your bank yet.
I did last week. Give me a sec. The knife.
Let him spend his money, LS.
The knife, the bayonet. I know you're trying to leave me on an evil path, Slinger. I'm not saying yes to this, by the way.
We're trying to bring some self-control to you.
Anyway,
some investment.
Think of who you're talking to.
Ripley, have you found anything you like yet?
To buy?
Yeah?
No.
What are you doing with your money?
And then as far as my other two, I couldn't find anything I wanted to put points in right now.
You can put it in the bank, right?
Yeah,
you
can have it in your pocket, or it's up to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you look at your care sheet, Rip, it says the retirement milestones, there's a bounty bank. That goes in there, that doesn't come out. That's for retirement.
Okay.
The savings, that you can use that on whatever the fuck you want.
Putting two, so I'm gonna say in my savings I have two.
Okay. Fine.
Okay. I changed my mind. I wanna buy a drive. I wanna drive.
You wanna drive, okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So I only have one in
drugs?
Savings.
Okay.
Drugs would work too, but anyway.
Yeah, I thought you said drugs too, and I was like, okay, what kind? There's quite a few of them actually in this game.
Can I do that though, or does that exceed my points that I started with?
No,
that's not how that works, Rip, at all.
You
pay.
Okay, so I'm putting one in drive, and I only have one in savings then.
Yeah, Slinger, I'll take your
You want the bayonet?
Yeah, I'll go for it.
All right,
that's minus four, leaving me with five to go into the bank.
All right, you're putting that in your bounty bag. What are you up to, Gray?
I'm up to 12.
Ooh, you're getting very close to the success now.
I am. No, it's fight and flight first. That's me getting my plane.
Yeah,
success is when I put rockets on it.
Success is when you put the rockets on it. Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. All right, so Jim, Phil, you guys both good on all your shit?
So I've got 17 bounty, 6. My upgrade is 6. That leaves me with
you got 11.
11.
Yep.
I'm going to leave it in my pocket.
All of it?
Yep.
Ooh, shit, son. Give me a self-control roll for that.
What?
You ain't filing away for the future. Give me a self-control roll for that shit. I want to.
You want to know why?
I want to
put any money in the bank.
He's not.
So, I failed it. I failed it.
Failed it? All right, give me one to stress. Like, time is ticking away. Things are not good. You know, something bad's out there.
Why would you do that?
Anyways, Jim,
you're not
go ahead.
Hugh Hefner.
You'll see it in a
right.
Minute.
So I added one to explosives.
All right.
Under shoot, so that I'll also be able to use my grenade launcher now. I added one to drive because it's pathetic how few drivers we had.
Did warn you guys, it's DayZ, you're gonna have vehicles.
That's the first thing I said. I was like, I want to be drive. I want to be able to shoot from a vehicle.
I
can drive, but just choose not to.
For that exact same reason, I've also put one in mechanics.
Okay, nice.
I've invested a lot in my character this round. So
yeah.
Also, sure. I found that my hawk was a bit unreliable, so I've increased my animal handler to 2.
All right.
So that's how many is that so far?
That's 2
one.
Bounty. So you've spent 5. So you got shoot the grenade launcher,
you got
drive, mechanics, and then you bumped up animal handling, which would cost you 2 because it's going up to 2. So that'll be 5 total so far. Yep.
Perfect. Okay. And then I've also upgraded my UB specs to give me the VATS hacking, Deadeyes hack.
All right. For shooting. Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
I thought it was pretty cool.
I dig it. That's 6.
That's it. And then. Yeah, that makes sense because I I think I had 7 after all my maintenance, and I've just got 1 that I'm just going to take with me. I'm just going to take it with me, man. I might need it if I need to, like, if I need to sweet talk someone.
Cool. So, everybody good on spending their money?
Yep.
Right,
vignette time.
Fuck it, I'll go first.
All right, Greg, you got shot in the fucking chest and nearly bled to death.
Please have PTSD.
Does he have any like injuries?
Yeah.
What do you have left, Greg? Did you heal up?
I healed him, didn't I?
The stun.
No,
I just healed him to stun. I think I just healed him to stun, didn't I?
Okay.
And it's all in the stun now.
Okay.
Is this an opportunity to heal myself then?
The opportunity was the end of last game session, but I'll be nice. It costs you bounty though to do that.
Doctors aren't free, man.
This isn't the NHS. This isn't the NHS for fuck's sake.
So how much bounty do you have left, Gray?
I put it all in the bank, man.
Did you? All right. So, I'll give you one for free. So either your chest or your leg, you can heal all the stun for free.
Oh, no, this is a decision, because I have some green in my chest, but I'm all yellow in my leg.
Yeah.
But if you lose your body, you're dead.
Yeah, if you lose your torso, you do die, but it's all just stun.
Yeah, the stun has to turn into killing. Let's take it off the leg.
Okay. So he's healing his leg.
And I'm going to see first aid.
It takes a little while for your bone marrow to reproduce blood. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. You almost bled out. It's not like there's a ton of blood bags floating around this place, so...
What are you on about?
Me and Phil up first, though.
You did go to Electro. You can touch him. Buddy's using them on all of the desperate people he wants to win over.
God damn it, buddy.
You're playing Croc. All right, great. So what are you doing? Set the scene for me so I can play the scene out for you. What are you and Croc doing in Starry right now?
Well, I'm doing my natural way of coping with sad times.
Are you drinking?
I'm drinking right now. Yeah.
You're drinking? All right, that's fine. I can work with that. Yeah.
I've had several pints of vodka clean.
Yeah. Yeah, you're friggin' down and up. Croc, how do you feel about this? Like, Sassy's not saying much. He's just drinking. A lot.
Thanks so much for last time. What's up? What? Are you fucking drunk? Sassy, wake up. Eat this powdered coffee. Eat this dry coffee. Here comes the choo-choo train.
Get out of the way,
here comes the choo-choo train.
Get out of the way.
Yeah.
No. No.
All right, so as Croc tries to force feed you the dry coffee, he accidentally, slaps your leg. Instantly, you just feel the sound of that bullet tearing into your leg. And just the horror as you laid there, bleeding out, with all of your friends gone, none of them responding on Ubix specs, because Phil doesn't have Ubix specs, so he didn't call back to you. You just laid there, knowing some crazy asshole that you just shot at, and just blown your leg off, as far as you knew. You're on the ground now, screaming about your leg as all of the pub members are like, why do we still let this fucking Irishman come in here? Seriously. Greg, go ahead and heal one line of your mental health, whatever you want to heal. What are you biggest in? Trauma, stress. I would guess?
Stress. You give it like
stress?
Stress.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, clear stress.
I'm a clean boy.
Yeah. Well done. Okay, let's just go right into Jim. So, Jim, what do you want to do? You got cope. You can PTSD out. You didn't really have a lot of PTSD stuff, though. You can support. You can do something for Abuelita and Cosford and the lot, or you can engage and tell us something new about Starry.
So in Starry, because obviously I used to work in the circus, and little Pepe as well was a little orphan working in the circus with me. So he's like a gymnast and he can juggle and shit. So in Starry, we put on little displays. We go out there and we just do some circus shit. A little tent we salvaged.
Okay.
And then we leave out a little hat for either money, which normally we don't get any,
yeah,
or kind of bullets as well. We get some handfuls of bullets and shit thrown in, some useful shit sometimes.
So it's kind of a metro. It's kind of a metro economy you've got going.
Yeah,
totally makes sense. Okay, I dig it. So Starry has a circus. Let's just do a quick scene.
Really cool option,
who played
by
Pepe?
The way. I love that. I love that option about the bat engage. I think that's really interesting.
No, it's super cool, and it's nice. Although... Like sometimes you don't have a bad session. And it's like I want to talk more about my world and like make it more lived in. Rip, you want to play Pepe?
Pepe, very poor English, quiet, disturbed child. Yeah, I can play that.
Okay, cool. Ripley, what was Pepe's specialty in the circus?
I was suggesting you were like a gymnast, but you could kind of advance on that because you were like this little orphan boy, grew up in the circus with me.
Okay, I'm a child, and I like swinging on the trapeze bars.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's
like Robin.
So okay, so,
well,
so
the
fun.
Well, the levy hounds set up some janky ass pull up bars like outside of the mess hall because they're still got that militant mindset, so they have to do 5 pull ups before they can go get chow. So yeah, you guys can set up your little tent right there just outside the chow hall actually, so people
show.
So fun spin.
Yeah, so spin, yeah. Yeah, so Jim, Pepe's pointing at the bar saying spin.
Yeah, okay, all right, so we're doing this show in front of all the other, in front of all the guards who are off duty. Or
just everybody's kind of coming and going, but yeah, like the levy hounds are all like kind of smoking right next to it, because that's a weird thing.
And
I'm just jumping up and spinning around.
Pepe, sube la barra, sube la barra. Up the bar, sube la barra. And then he just goes off like a fucking monkey.
Yeah.
And he's like 10 years old, but he's got like, but he can lift like 3 times his weight. He's like a fucking ant. And he's just swinging around doing crazy shit.
Yep.
And all the while I'm doing some just like stupid gymnastics dancing. I'm kind of doing more of a jester thing, like juggling it like 5 balls at once, you know.
Well, the levy hounds don't really, they're kind of smoking, but a handful of Hacker Hopes workers come out and they start applauding. Nice. Yeah, they actually throw some food to Pepe.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Ooh, food.
Oh, brilliant. Good job, man.
Yeah.
Give Pepe, Joker. And we high five. Joker, Theo.
So is that, that's, so this is where Pepe is going to hang out while you're out working, Jim, from now on out? He's going to, you just have him keep doing
I'd like to, shit, can I find a contact to kind of,
look after, I don't know who, keep an eye on him.
Maybe Cosford can sit there as well, because maybe it'll make him less angry to watch
Pepe
training all the time.
Makes it. Stick Cosford then, outside of the chow hall around a bunch of professional soldiers.
And you come back and Cosford is missing.
I thought that Abwali Duggar should be racist to all the white soldiers. No.
I thought you were just going to call them
which
the
white. Which there are a lot of, because the levy hounds are mostly Americans.
I'm going to ask the group. Guys, does anyone have a fucking person at home?
A standard dependent.
Is it any of these dependents who aren't like so fucked they need to be at home?
I have...
Oh, you've got Gordon. You've got Gordon.
No. That makes it too fun, though, and too normal.
Too normal. And a grizzled SAS guy watching a fucking kid is
normal. Yeah, no, so normal.
Please do that, because that can lead into our Robin story when he becomes just Robin. What? He's a fucking trapeze gymnast. He's an
trained
orphan
by the military.
He grew up in a circus. He's gonna get trained by a fucking SAS. Military
martial arts motherfucker. I'm using Market Veto. That's canon. Yeah,
that's,
Gordon
that,
is going to you somehow managed to convince Gordon.
Gordon's skin, isn't he? Gordon's skin. God. So he'll take any work if it's just sitting next to a fucking kid and like watching them.
I'm gonna add a little note on the Pepe like future badass. He's young at the moment, but future badass.
He is the future.
He'll never learn English. He'll never learn good English.
Yeah,
no. He'll say a bunch of Spanish stuff, and everybody will be like, "What the fuck?" And then they just kill them all.
He was already
a quiet, disturbed child.
Jim, go ahead and heal up one of your mental health damage.
I have nothing to heal.
Oh, okay, cool.
I'm not damaged. I'm great. I'm feeling great.
I'll leave this aside as a potential future side job thing. If you guys need it, I don't think we'll get into that too much since we're testing war rules, but this is funny enough. I might be willing to do that. It is red markets and you guys do need money. So yeah, we'll come back to that. Long shots, your turn. So what is going on with Freddy and Gordon other than Gordon, you know, being out and hanging out with Kaz?
Yeah,
which he already kind of was, if he was making sure Freddy didn't, like, turn.
Well, make it canon that he's fucking literally, like, training up Pepe.
Yeah, but Huate doesn't know about it. Huate doesn't know about this, but Gordon, like,
That's pretty funny.
Former SAS member.
Yeah, no, that's pretty funny.
He's like, you need to survive. This kid needs to survive out here. I need to teach him shit.
Let's be honest, the grizzled SAS guy is not going to immediately be like, I love this kid.
No, you're not wrong.
But he knows that everybody needs to get skills to survive the apocalypse. Yeah. He knows that if this kid's going to survive the apocalypse, he needs to know how to fight.
Yeah, of course. Like Carol. Right. Carol fucking called it while The Walking Dead.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, exactly.
All right, LS, cope, supporter, engage. What do you want to do? What do you need to heal?
I need to heal one trauma. That's
okay.
Do you want
a PTSD out? Do you want to cope? You're in prime position for coping. We're going to cope.
Fuck it.
Let's cope. What are you doing? Are you hanging out with Freddy? Are you over with Gordon and Pepe? Is Gordon with you right now? Is Pepe off alone? What set the scene for us? What are you doing? You've been banned from karaoke night, so you're not at karaoke night. It's
fucking shit.
Maybe you were just watching the show we just put on.
Yeah, I'm watching the show with Gordon. This is like the. I'm also unaware that Gordon is going to be like.
No one knows what Gordon's up to.
Gordon's armed because he has convinced the Levy Hounds that he's reliable in case you or Freddy turn.
He's done some jobs on the side for him.
Yeah. So yeah, no, you and Gordon are hanging out. There's no guards hanging with you because Gordon's there. You know, he's got his Sig Sauer. You guys are watching Pepe spin on the bars, and
I feel I need to be knocking back a couple of drinks as well, just because.
Are you drinking?
Okay.
Is everybody going to be drunk?
Not heavy drinking. Not heavy.
I mean, last time you stumbled out of a bar, and the Levy Hounds
established bars, so they are the two most likely to be drinking.
I just need to be having one or two.
That's what they always say.
It's to replace karaoke night in my.
Oh yeah, you're banned from karaoke night.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. I'm getting so close to depression with my character because I've been banned from karaoke night. I'm about to PTSD the fuck out.
Yep.
You are.
I've got to look after my fucktard of a latent brother. It's like a rabbit. It literally just hops along, does fuck all day. Just dependent upon me for everything.
Gordon, what are you, what are your kind of thoughts right now? What are you thinking as you guys stand there and watch this little gypsy child spinning on the pull-up bars?
He's only turning, he's gonna have to survive somehow out here. It's just not a place for kids, but there's no kids around here anymore. Never. They need to be stronger. They need to be able to, like, hold the line. If they can't hold the line, then we're all done for.
Great. No, yeah. And as he talks about holding the line and stuff, Lark cuts, yeah, you see yourself trying to hold the line as you go zipping out across the open field and the sounds of the dishgums kind of reverberate through your chest. And then it's the sound of Zelenogors coming alive. Well, I mean, not alive, but you know what
dead
I mean.
Alive.
the moans and stuff, and like, yeah, the people kind of shuffling out of the chow hall are like, they're not bumping into you because you're still wearing your Leighton jacket, and they're like, nah, fuck not.
But
you hear like kind of the mass of humanity coming out because it's like lunchtime.
And they're all bumping into each other and shit.
It's shuffling, and all of a sudden you gotta run. Like, yeah, you take off. You're just booking it. The Levy Hounds are all like going for their weapons. Gordon, what's Gordon doing as Lockshots takes off?
He reaches for his gun, but also watches. Paul, where are you going? What's going on?
Yeah, he doesn't listen to you. He's just hearing the shuffling, and he's like, I gotta get high. And he just busts into the Acker Hopes area. He just starts climbing up into the rafters of the barn that Buddy's converted over into his headquarters.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
Much to everybody's chagrin, you know, Buddy doesn't. Obviously, he's one of Buddy's workers, so like, yeah, Buddy's not too pissed. He's just like, what the fuck? As a bunch of Levy Hounds.
Gordon runs to the bottom of the tower, try to cool him down.
So yeah, that happened. Go ahead and heal that trauma, LS.
Yay.
Yay.
I'm mentally scarred in real life as well as English.
Oh, it's not that bad. You're not as bad as George yet. Don't forget, George has got to make rolls every game to not lose his fucking shit.
Oh, yeah.
Ripley, this will be your first spin yet. Practice so, first off, good. Who's going to play Newt? Who would you like to play Newt?
I don't care.
Well,
Newt's just the girl.
Jim. Yes.
Jim? All right, Jim.
Sorry, who's Newt?
Newt's the little girl I found when I was scavenging.
So she's a little Chernarusian girl. So
how old is she? Does she speak English?
She's probably about 8.
Okay, maybe. All right.
Yeah, all right. 7, 8, something
does
like
that. Does she speak any English?
Yep.
Is there any other directions you want to give Jim? Because once you turn this over, it's his character. Jim. Just like you took over Pepe and get to define him. So, yeah. Speak now for every piece.
So be careful.
Jim's character.
Maybe I should have picked somebody else. I forgot I was Pepe for
Jim's
Jim.
Really
anyway.
Good. Jim's doing really good.
No, Jim was awesome for this.
Yeah, she saw a lot of crap, but she's pretty tough little cookie. And that's about it.
So yeah, pretty prototypical Russian. Like think the family and Justice League, as god awful as that movie was. That was probably the best part. Like, yeah, this is a bunch of, you know, monsters that hunt on fear, and they're just living in their house, like no big deal. Like they never gets found, you know, that kind of shit. All right, Ripley. So you have three scene types you can pick from. Currently, Starry has two bars. One of them is a latent bar that's outside the fence line. Latistan pub is inside the fence line. We actually haven't named the pub. That's where Gray frequents and Croc are at a lot. There's the internet cafe, the med center where you spend some time the first game you're in. There is a statue of a dildo in honor of the dildo factory along the coast.
I don't even
there's the garage.
Know. Yeah.
I want to do the
isn't
middle
it bright
one.
Pink?
Is
it
you want to do a support?
Is
okay.
It's bright pink.
Jim,
the mighty girl.
Dude has a problem. What is that problem?
Life is okay here. I feel better than on the outside. But there are no children. Why are there no children? I'm the only child here.
Except for Pepe.
I'm going crazy.
Newt, you know what we need to do? She needs to go over and meet Pepe.
Oh my god.
Okay.
This is going to be interesting.
Because she's 7 or 8 and Pepe is 10, right?
And you're both playing the opposite characters. This is going to be golden.
That won't work.
It's great. This is going to be great.
It's great. We're doing this.
It's not going to be great because Gordon's going to get roped into teaching.
He's chasing freaking...
Oh, I have already taught.
We're going to end up with a
surrogate daughter how to protect herself.
You're going to have an army of child soldiers.
We're
going to
end up with a bunch of... We're going to have Robin and Batgirl. We're
going to have the whole fucking package.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. Supergirl.
Pony Y.
I'm so excited for like
Top
a future campaign.
Wonder Woman when she grows up. This is awesome.
Maybe a future campaign where we're all older and more decrepit. And we've got
we're the dependent. Yeah. We're the fucking dependents.
Turned Gordon into Coney. I don't know why.
Tony,
all right,
of course
you would. Let's go over here. I've got a friend I want you to meet.
So yeah, you guys got to
introduce
each other.
Okay.
So yeah, there's got to be conflict to the scene.
There
I'm
has
going
to be conflict?
Yeah, that's... It's just an age. It's a game. Like that. It's just part of the game.
Make it interesting.
I'm going to say that
Pepe doesn't like me.
No, we're not going to do something like that. That's not quantifiable. How to solve that?
Okay.
I'm going to say one of the local Chernarusians complained to Mr. Pink about the wild child flipping around on the bars outside of the jail hall. So Mr. Pink was forced to shut down the show temporarily. So yeah, currently Pepe is now detained by the Livy House. You guys need to go talk to the Livy House and get Pepe out of lockup.
Okay.
What the
Burn Starry to the floor.
Okay, Newt, somewhere around here was Pepe, but we can't find him. So we're going to have to go find... I can't even remember. Huate, are you using Huate as your name?
Yeah, he's Huate.
Okay, we need to go find Huate and see what happened
citizen.
To Pepe. Yes?
Are you looking for the boy?
We are. Have you seen him?
Yeah, we just put him in lockup about 10 minutes ago.
Lockup? What's he doing in lockup?
Well, there were some complaints from some of the local citizenry. There's a bit of distraction. They didn't actually appreciate...
I want to talk to Pink.
Mr. Pink is currently on mission.
You need to get him on the Ubispec so I can talk to him.
Won't be possible. They're currently blacked out. I could get Mr. White. That's the number 3. Well, I guess he's number 2 now that Mr. Orange got shot.
All right, I'll talk
to Electro.
White. Give me All Mr.
Right.
White.
Come with me, citizen. And yeah, he escorts you off. Okay. So yeah, you guys go over to the Levy Hound staging area, which, as I recall, was over on the west side of town where they had that shooting range that Grace... Was it Gray or... No, it was Jim that stumbled
Jim,
into it. Cosford. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, no, you see a bunch of friggin' mercs are sitting there cleaning weapons
Newt,
and shit.
Stay behind me.
Okay. Mama.
Who's Mr. White? I'm asking the question. Which one of you gentlemen is Mr. Oh, White?
Well, you see a giant Samoan turn around.
He's got a white bandana, no?
Yeah. Think Haloti Nagata, the football player. Like he's not like ripped like the Rock or anything, but he's that big. Like he's like 6'7". He's huge.
He's got a pink sash that says Mr. White on it.
He's like, I'm Mr. White. How can I help you, citizen?
Mr. White, you've got a little boy over here somewhere that you're detaining?
Yes, he's currently in lockup. There were some complaints about him grifting outside of the chow hall and being a distraction.
He wasn't grifting. He was just being a child, and I need to... He and my little girl here, Newt, they need to meet each other. We need to take them over, maybe even make a playground over there on the east side, past the barn.
That'd be heartwarming, but I don't think there's a lot of resources for that currently. But obviously, we don't want to cause any duress to this child or to your child. However, there's protocols to this. The complaint
He's not
filed.
My mom.
It's okay, Newt. It's okay. She's not my little girl. Her parents died. But I'm acting as her mother.
Oh, of course.
So it's okay, Newt. It's okay. Wait a second.
Well, look.
It's a worthless...
You want to be straight? You're American, right?
Yes.
Look, I gotta be straight with you, all right? Like, you know, this is my third tour. I'm really aiming for a promotion here. Like, Pink's got rules. Like, I gotta follow the rules. The locals were complaining. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I can't be seen, like, putting the foot down. This isn't like when I was in the army, okay? I can't just go kicking doors and shit. Like, I gotta follow Pink's rules. Yeah.
But since Mr. Pink isn't here and you can't talk to him, that means you're the one in charge.
Yes.
And as being the one in charge, you need to look at the entire situation.
Well,
and
I have looked at the entire situation.
But you
the
haven't,
situation
because
was,
if you
little
leave
boy
a child
was...
in lockup, you leave a little child in lockup, then other people are going to get even more upset. And you're going to have even more people upset than the one or two who complain to you.
Well, look, here's what I can do. If you can go find these people and convince them to drop this nonsense, I'll let
I'll
them get
it.
Out.
I'll
All right. It. Yeah. So, thank you.
Who were they?
They own the supermarket. They're over there. You see that? Fucking Russians all look the same. Like, those. He points at a couple walking outside the supermarket in Starry. Yeah. What's left of it, anyways.
Okay. Let's go, Newt.
So, you go over. Walk in. Crunch, crunch, crunch as you walk across.
Crunch, crunch, crunch.
Broken
okay.
glass. Yeah. it's this place is a wreck. Like, yeah. They turn around and...
Can I speak with you for a moment?
Yeah. Yeah.
I understand that the little boy that was playing on the bars, just spinning around, upset you.
Dirty gypsies!
But
are
he is
you the
okay.
No,
okay.
That's Pepe.
No,
that's Pepe.
Pepe's in jail. How can
yeah, but it's Starry. It's not that big. He's in a lockup.
Oh,
he's in a fucking...
he can hear them.
Yeah, he's in a fence. Like, they threw up some chicken wire. No, dirty gypsy. No. Not outside there. We this is a professional place. No, we can't have this. It's not right. Just the dead live. Do you understand? Like our ancestors they come back, they eat us.
We can't tolerate this. Do you see this little girl? She's one of you. And we are taking her in and we are taking care of her as one of our own. You could try and open up your hearts a little bit and take that little boy. Just, we're not asking you to take him in or take care of him, but you could cut him a little slack for being a little boy.
Give me a persuasion test, Ripley.
I don't have it.
Okay, what do you have in charisma? Like, this is a charisma test. You're trying to convince these people. Like,
in charisma.
Yeah, what do you
I
got?
I have one in sensitivity.
I'll say you could give him a bounty to drop the charges. Yeah.
Okay.
Spend one of your bounty. Yeah.
Okay, I'll do it. So I pull that out of savings? So now I have nothing?
Yeah, basically.
Okay. Done.
All right, give me a self-control check, because that's the last of your money to make these people fuck off.
9 and 4.
So yeah, they drop the charges, Pepe gets turned loose, and yeah, they go off to try and work it out, between the broken English and not, you know, universally understood language. So yeah, that's a vignette. Spygon, last one. What are you doing?
I will
support and engage.
Support.
You want to support? Okay. What does Crab need?
Gray.
Oh God.
Crab.
So he wants seafood.
Crab can't eat crab. No.
Gray, I need an actual answer from you. Stop role playing. Is that what you want? You want seafood?
I want to fight a crab.
Oh, so you actually want crab battle?
I want to. Yes.
All right. So yeah. Crab's a little distressed, Spygon. He wants to kill a crab. So
How do I know that he wants to kill a crab?
Gray, what is crab doing across what he actually wants here?
So I'm holding up my left fist.
Uh-huh.
Putting up two little tendrils with my other hand, pulling out like little claws.
Yeah.
And moving it side to side. And then moving my hands away to punching towards the direction that my hand-made crab was in.
There you go. Screaming
crab battle.
I have no idea what the hell you just did. a crab. Okay. Where the fuck am I going to find a crab in Star Wars?
Well, research or network if you have either of those.
I got neither of them.
Well, that'll make life difficult. Give me a criminality roll to know some black market. You know there's
oh yeah, that's a good shout. That's a good shout.
Yeah, give me a criminality check.
Roll. Fail.
Fail?
Fail.
You want to spend a will to flip it?
No.
All right. Yeah. You can't get him.
I don't understand what he's asking. What are you asking, brother? Brother, what are you asking? You say that all the time. I don't understand. I'm sorry, brother. I just don't understand.
All right. Yeah. Do you... I will... You can either let him go needy or you can give me an awareness check.
I will awareness
one
check.
One last chance.
Come on.
Awareness check? Okay.
Why are you fuckers so broken?
I'm not. I've got one stress from like 2 minutes ago. And it's fucking ruining my life because my dependent.
Why did you name your brother Crab?
Critical success!
Okay.
Oh my god.
So, you're at the pub because
it's some crab fisherman. No.
Well, you overhear one of those smugglers who, yeah, he brought in some food from the ocean to the we never just, what is the pub? What is the pub?
It doesn't have a name.
It doesn't have a name.
He doesn't have a name. Oh. We need a name for him. Name.
The Rusty.
Rusty. No, just leave it there. Rusty.
Rusty? Okay.
Rusty.
Yeah, Rusty. Rusty.
Okay,
what a cute name for a pub.
No, that's the name of the pub.
No, that's not the pub. That's the pub tender's name.
Oh, my.
What's the name of the pub?
We haven't got a name for it.
We still haven't named the damn thing yet.
One thing at a time, guys.
Someone's going to need to do that for Engage at some point.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll deal with that
so,
later.
So, yeah. You hear Rusty talking about Crab. Yeah, and I'll say you can go over and flex up on it.
Suddenly it all makes sense. It all aligns. The crab battle and the crab. Suddenly I get it. I understand what he's after.
Okay, yeah. So yeah. You go over there and, do you got Intimidate?
No. I have...
You have?
Deception. I can lie.
Okay, yeah, lie to him. Yeah, give him a lie that you're going to turn him in or something if he doesn't give you one of the crabs.
Like, do you know, like, Starry is starving for food? Do you know, does Buddy know that you're carrying this shit around?
You take her. I know you dirty.
I work with Buddy. Dirty. I've worked with Buddy. We're pretty tight with him. I'm sure he's not aware that you're carrying around seafood.
Nobody.
Yeah, but Buddy will want to know about this. You need to give me some of that, or I'm going to Buddy.
Give me a roll.
That is 10 to 6.
Right, yeah. He
really wanted you to fail.
He hands you a It's like a shitty fish aquarium with a crab in it. Like, it's a big one too. Yeah, it's a pretty good sized one.
I try and slowly carry it across Starry without looking too suspicious with the fucking giant crab.
Give me a stealth test, Phil.
You know how heavy water is.
So that is a.
You're carrying the equivalent
7 to 6.
You managed to make a levy hound kind of like squints at you, but you managed to make it around the corner for you. Yeah, so crab gets his crab, and they battle.
Please make him roll for this.
I've just rolled four times. Leave me the fucking alone.
No, not Phil. Make Adam roll.
What's crab stats?
Yeah, Greg. Give me.
I want to roll for this. I want to fight this fucking check crab.
Give me a melee check with a melee of one. No, an unarmed.
Critical failure. Crab gets his head cut off by a crab.
Rifle.
Nope. It's not. Greg. It's not. It's crab.
It's crab.
Oh my god. Rifle.
Give me a test with a plus one for unarmed. What?
I've lost.
A crab is just like snapped at his fingers.
It cuts his hand and it scutters out of the room and heads out into the street. It's away.
I've lost away. Again.
Lost oh my god! Again. He's speaking English. Crab, are you alright? I'm sorry, mate. You're there! I know you're there! Come on, man! Crab, talk to me, brother!
Crab battle.
Go ahead and heal, Phil.
I started this play with nothing on the board, and then somehow I get so much stress from, like, trying to get rid of stress I don't have.
How the fuck did you lose a fight against the crab?
Crab's a fucking dangerous
man.
Yeah, he's not got the motor skills.
All right. Well, with vignettes done, it's time for job hunting.
All right.
Indeed.com and the pink job are both still open. Have received a message. It's encrypted. Okay. LS, give me an awareness check.
9 to 7. There you go.
All right. Yeah, you recognize the code. It's the Gunslinger. DMC might be sending you a job.
Ooh.
Well, I can start with you, Longshots. Do you want to find out what the job is?
Can I call a meeting?
Sure.
Yeah, okay, right. So, everybody in the bar, we need to sit down and talk about something.
We're at the round table.
Yes.
Wait, everybody in the bar?
Yeah, everybody.
I'm not allowed in the bar because I'm a late.
You're allowed
in the bar!
Oh, okay, we're doing it somewhere else. We're not in the bar. Is he allowed in the Leighton bar now?
Of course, he's allowed in the Leighton bar, he's just not allowed to.
Karaoke night. That's fair enough. Right, guys. So we've been sticking our neck out a lot for a lot of people lately. Obviously, we've been sticking our neck out for Greece. We've been doing it for Buddy. So we stuck our neck out for all these people, and we're forgetting something. We're not sticking our neck out for one person, and that's ourselves. And as much as I love Starry, Starry's been good to us, it's not ours. The problem is eventually we're going to like get either dragged into someone else's fight or Starry's going to get hit and we're going to have to pick sides. So my thing is, while I was out walking back in the day, I came across a place. It's at 3781 9376 in Chernarus. It's not far away. It's well defended. It is very easily to be defendable. It's got walls, it's got fences. My plan is we go up there, clear it out, and take it over.
Where is it?
3781 9376.
It's the one that says Green Mountain, right?
Is it Green Mountain?
Yeah.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, I heard about that place.
Yes.
I've heard of it too. I've seen it when I've been out scouting.
So,
is there a bar near there?
Oh, it's not too far from Starry, so that's the advantage. Is it's not too far from Starry, so we can come back at any time. But we're out of the way.
There's lots of storage you can bring.
Down. Long shots. Give me a foresight check.
Critical success 6-6.
He's psychic.
You pull out your laptop, LS, and you open up. Did you tell everybody you got that about that message that came in? That you recognize, the encrypted one?
I told Jim and Sassy.
Okay.
So you're waiting, Sassy.
Yeah, you yeah. crack open and open it up, and you set the laptop down, turn around, shove it over to Spygon, because you decrypted it. And he sees a message from Gunslinger offering you guys a job to secure Green Mountain Signal Tower.
Holy shit. Well, this is...
Spygon with the...
And you just, probably should have 2000 called this meeting.
So Longshot yeah. just kind of shrugs at you. Like, sure, why not, mate?
Yeah.
You paid for it, right?
Originally, we were going to go in freebone for ourselves, but if we can make money at the same time, and also we'll keep all the episodes wondering why we're up there, because we're just doing a job. We're not going up there to settle. They don't know that.
Is that costing me a charge?
Also, this Gunslinger yes. is fucking leech yeah, shit, so, you know... Maybe not such a bad ally to have.
No, definitely. Less, well, like, yeah. But I was thinking, I was...
just agreed strong yeah. with this.
Like, you did shoot him. You did shoot him first.
Everything he fucking deserved, because he's off comms, he doesn't know what the fuck's happening, he's just a fucking cunt.
I'm on comms, I just don't like what you're saying.
Yeah, so you guys want to...
Long shots!
Do you guys just want to accept the job, or do you want to actually do your due diligence on it, do your research on it?
But I was thinking, like, we get some help this time. We get some backup. So I was thinking of LS, like, go and do a quick, like, jump on the net, see if there's any free agents, anybody out there that would happily take a job with us.
Wait, I've got an idea.
What's up?
Leading on from this is very related. Adam, you'll never have a sustainable vodka emporium. It's a fucking pipe dream.
Fucking hell. Are you starting?
Wow.
What?
Right, let's not have a fight in the fucking Leighton bar, guys.
Starting.
Gray and wait, give me self-control test.
At this point, I'm pulling out the shotgun.
No, yeah, you are yeah, not. In the middle of the Leighton bar, you're going to get a shot.
I succeed.
Yeah, it's tense, but it's yeah. not to the point of like...
Calm it down, guys. We'll sort this out later. We do not need you two at each other's throats if we're going to go out there.
So,
you
want some NPC help.
He's so pissed off.
Yeah. You want some NPC help, Phil.
Yeah.
How do you want that to play out? Like, that's asking a lot.
Well, I got some 10 bounty in my pocket.
Oh, you're throwing up a bounty?
Yeah.
I have the Professionals Enmeshed app.
Okay.
Which provides me with additional networking online.
Uh-huh.
So he's going to see,
potentially
like...
potentially use that?
Yeah,
to try to find
give me a networking
guys.
Test if you want to put out the call for the bounty.
I always put out what?
What? Jim, give me a foresight check.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I've rolled mine.
It's fine. Hold it. Just hold it.
Okay.
Yeah, I smash it like 12-5.
Okay, well, Jim leans in and points out that is it such a good idea to be asking for help when we've been offered a job? You know, usually people that offer jobs kind of want you to, you know, do it on the down low.
I agree.
Yep.
I don't want to agree with
very
this
good point.
Dream-crossing bastard, but I agree.
Is Gunslinger going to appreciate us fobbing this off on someone else, in effect?
Well, okay, no, I can.
What do you know about the man so far? Since you guys haven't really researched him at all, like,
I don't think he cares as long as the job gets done.
You basically, go off of what you know, and that being that
he shot me.
He shot Grant.
He's good with a rifle.
He shot all the bandits. He can
so
fly
why?
An
so
by himself.
Why are we?
So,
why
so
are we trying
question...
to piss this guy off, Phil?
Well, no. The question
well,
is.
The question is why,
is why isn't he doing
do
it?
That is the question, isn't it?
Yeah.
Since you guys are electing not to research your job.
I would like to research. Why is nobody wanting to research?
Well, I was just trying to see like what assets we had available, but maybe having another group involved at the moment is too much.
Long shots. What was that roll you had, by the way?
It was a 5-4.
Okay, so you did succeed. That's good. Would have been real bad if you failed.
We would have got 0-4-V or someone to come along and kill us.
10 bounties for going to go check out Green Mountain. That's a hop, skip, and a jump. 0-4-V's base is only like not even 2 kilometers away. That's no big deal.
Let's rope like these assholes.
For a cakewalk, no problem. 2.5. Whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you didn't fail. So yeah, you could potentially put out there and draw in some help. I'm gonna make you roll to see.
Probably not a good idea then, because if we're gonna set up there, we don't need anybody else knowing we're there. So that's
no, Phil, you're not fucking backpedaling on this.
I can backpedal. You convinced me. You convinced me.
We don't need anyone else.
Yeah, we can go in quiet.
Involved here with Phil, so like, yeah, Phil can roleplay his character however he wants.
Yeah, no, you guys have been telling me like why this is a shit idea, and I think actually, yeah, you're actually right. Maybe not having another team knowing where we're gonna set up. Sure.
Exactly. You're talking about getting a new home, and you're like inviting people we've just met.
Well, we haven't
met
them.
Met yet at this
no,
point.
Exactly. They could be anybody.
Look at our heist. Look at all of our lovely things you can
rob us for.
Pillages for.
I'm
no,
just in
I
awe at the fact.
Entirely.
No, okay, yeah. No, I'm listening to you guys, and I think yeah, you're making sense. You're making all right. sense.
So, do you guys want to do your due diligence, or you just want to contact him and just it doesn't matter what he's paying. Let's just go. Let's get it.
No, yeah. I need him. I'd rather find out what he's paying.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. How are you going to find out?
He could be giving us pennies and just doing this.
Well, a minute ago, I was going to go
what
there anyway.
You have, Sassy, because bear in mind, he's contacting you digitally.
And directly.
He's a myth to most people.
And he's talking to us directly. That's
yeah.
I so, have, I know you've expect.
Uh-huh.
I want to say, like, that is probably the best non-derail I've ever done. Like, when you try and derail a campaign and it's the same place the DM wants you to go, is interesting.
I want you guys to go on a... I want to tell a particular story. Like, you guys won't go on your own. I'll goose you with a taser.
But well, that's what I thought.
That's really funny, actually, yeah, that Phil had you guys clearly had the same... You're at the same point,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I mean,
all I told Jace earlier, I said to Jace, I was like, I might derail the campaign slightly. And he was like, okay, and that was all we talked about.
And that was well after I'd written the job, so yeah, that had to
I've been thinking of this for the last 5 days.
You guys still have Pink and Buddy's jobs that you know about, so you guys could have not done it. You guys could have said, fuck that Gunslinger guy, he shot Gray.
Who's done what so far?
LS is gone. Everybody else can do something.
I could... Message into Gunslinger, couldn't I?
You could what?
I could message Gunslinger.
Okay,
what?
How is that going to go, Gray? I want to-
Oh yeah, you're his favorite person!
Do not fucking talk to him. Do not fucking talk to him.
I'm going to send him a message that you died.
Shut up! I want to hear this. Gray. Sassy.
So,
do tell me how this conversation is going to go between yourself and the Gunslinger.
Oh dear.
So I'm gonna start off with Yo-Yo. I write Yo-Yo to him.
And he just disconnects like that, instantly.
He connects, but it just sits there.
Hi, I'm the guy you shot.
He answers back, you mean the guy that shot me?
I don't know what you're talking about. Anyway.
Oh, really? So this bullet hole in my leg had nothing to do with a 7.62 semi-automatic rifle, huh?
Consider
one held by
a
imbecile sitting outside
consider
of
it a
bush.
Tattoo. It's a tattoo. So
Red,
I,
you
I'm
expect
let,
Son. Could have been
I'm
in communication with his career. Great.
So
what are you rolling to get some information from the
I'm not rolling yet. I'm still I'm having a conversation.
Oh, all right, you want to have a conversation? Let's
okay,
have a conversation. Let's motherfucking roleplay.
I get the vibe you know what you're doing. Let's be honest. You can get shot in the leg and do a 360 no-scope and blow me to smithereens. And I'm not going to lie, that was quite impressive. I'm one to accept that. Don't tell any of the guys, though.
Stop sucking his dick, man.
I'm really pissed off at you.
But I love you!
Really impressed. So
it's going somewhere?
It leads me to the question. So I understand you want us to go to Green Mountain, yes?
Yeah. I sent you boys a packet. Did they not read it yet?
We're in the process of discussing this, yes. But I do have one concern.
Uh-huh.
I watched you with an MV-22 tear shit up, 360 no-scope me, and the only reason you got hurt was because I thought it would be funny. What's the deal? I feel like you're sending us into some sort of ungraceful evil
trap,
by
maybe.
Sending us up there.
A trap.
What are you rolling?
I'm rolling sensitivity to see if he's going to lie to me.
Nope, you gotta get him to talk first.
He hasn't said anything.
That's persuasion. Yeah, persuasion?
No.
Yeah, he's kind of like, it's a job. Right. It needs getting done.
Take it or leave it.
You guys were in the area. It seemed like you guys might be the right crew for it. If you're not, there are others. I'll just hit them up with the same job. I'm sure people want to know. You could give me a... Give me a deception check.
Roll a deception?
Yeah, give me a deception check.
I failed.
All right.
Oh my god.
You know what you know, and he's like, yeah, take it or leave it.
Yes.
Well, let's try Adam.
Hope your leg feels better.
Ow. Oh!
He's got to say savage. Something else, hasn't he?
He is a savage. Yeah.
That is savage.
But he has to say the generic, next time you shoot me, you better fucking kill me.
Adam, do you want an ice pack, mate?
No, he's already clicked off, that's why I'm not responding.
Yeah it's like
I'm
over.
Just staring at the screen, open jawed.
He's just been done. Acutely aware that
everyone
he's done.
Can just see your Ubik specs are on, they don't know what you're seeing, but they see you gap jawing.
Yeah.
One eye.
Hey, Sassy, you're right there, man. You're right.
Yes, I'm okay. Don't worry about it. Everything's okay. Fine.
Who wants to get some information on their job?
I don't know how this will work, and maybe it won't. Is obviously I was a person that
everything I do ever
stumbled upon Green Mountain. Is there clues in my memory that would help about what's up there or who we're expecting to meet up there?
Give me a foresight check, and
yep.
I'll give you the competition.
And that's a 10 to a 5.
Okay.
Rolling 10
yeah,
to 5.
There is something out there.
I've seen like, something when I
passed
it.
You've seen something, yeah. You've actually seen it. Most people have heard of it in stories.
Okay.
Ghost stories around campfires, little kid stories. But you've seen something. There's something there.
I don't know what it is.
It's not going to want you to take. Nah, you have no fucking clue.
But
it's weird.
Something there.
It's
yeah.
Something. Something's
That's
there.
Why I didn't stay there originally, because I was like, what the fuck is this?
And there you go. Yeah. Something worth making ghost stories about. And these ghost stories are old. They exceed the Blight. They exceed the war.
I'm just going to straight up ask him. He'll be like, oh, so I'm asking the price, no? Is that what
like,
you guys want?
That's the last piece of information.
Yeah, that's all we need.
Did we get the competition?
It's something.
It's an unknown. It's an unknown hostile entity that exists on Green Mountain. I mean, you know, you win. So just give me some roleplay, just for the fun of it.
Sound cool, mate.
So obviously, we're mercenaries. We gotta know how much you're paying for this. Simple as.
Are we mercenaries?
Yeah. No, that's what he asked. He's like, "Are you mercenaries?"
Well,
judging by what I saw last week, I mean.
Well, you know, when there's no work to be done, yeah, I guess we're not mercenaries to kill everyone.
I'll pay you black 6, red 8. Might be the second highest paying job you guys have taken, I think.
Oh, yeah. I'm happy then. Sorry, I mean, that sounds very reasonable for our services.
All right, so is that it? Is that all you guys want to do? You want to just go straight to negotiations? Do you want to consider Buddy or Pink's jobs at all? Get any information on them?
Can we do some research on Gunslinger? Has anyone got research?
You can during negotiations.
Yeah, but,
you can get spots and stuff during negotiations like normal. Yeah.
I want to go to Green Mountain. I want to get out of Starry, so I'm more than happy to go on this mission.
Okay. Anybody disagreeing?
Nope.
All right, pulling up the negotiation tracker. Let's get your price dialed in.
Get the feeling he's going to shoot me, lads.
Oh, look, stop pissing him
off.
I can't
help but feel that this is some sort of...
Stop, like, making it out like it was a joke when you did shoot him.
Sassy, it's a risk we're willing to take.
It just seems too much like a trap.
Yeah, well, that's why we're going clever. We'll be quiet.
Have you seen our group?
All right, hey, enough side chat for a second. One by one, need you guys to give me your upkeeps, just real fast.
6.
11.
Akbar in this.
6.
11.
12.
LS? 12?
Upkeep?
Ripley? Yeah. It's on the back. It's on. All the upkeep of all your items.
Is this including the shotgun that I've acquired?
Yeah, it is.
Oh. Random outside thought. What happened to the Mark 48 that we told the SEALs to get off O4V?
We didn't get that.
Well, we told them that our payment But given them the code was a Mark 48, and they thought we were idiots because all we asked for was a Mark 48.
Yeah, I wasn't idiot, to be fair.
Hang on.
So what happened with this rogue Mark 48? That the sales were supposed to deliver. Did they deliver it?
They haven't fucking delivered it.
Well, no, they
no, no, they totally delivered it.
Seven. Okay. Who got that?
Who's only Phil who's heavy gunner.
Well, I'm a turret gunner. I don't have
machine gun. Slinger.
I have one in shoot. And
the basilisk body armor that I have, it says upkeep is 6 for purchase only.
Oh, okay, yeah. No, that's kind of important. Yeah, no, you don't add that in because it's just how much to buy it. Yeah, you don't add that to your upkeep. So
okay,
how much
so
is your
7.
Other... Okay.
7 is my total.
Most like body armor, you just buy it. You don't upkeep it. You don't upkeep it because you just use it. So yeah, when you get body armor is another really good like bang for buck because you just buy it. You don't pay upkeep on the shit.
Nice.
All right. So we got everything. Jim, I need a leadership test. Don't forget to give me the modifiers on it.
So are we just shoving this Mark 48 in the back of the Humvee for the moment?
Yeah.
Yep.
So what do you guys get? Shoot machine gun. You need shoot machine gun to shoot.
Oh, yep, that makes sense. It. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. 10-1.
10-1. Is that with modifiers?
Yeah, that's with modifiers.
Okay. It'll be 5 rounds. You guys have 5 rounds of negotiations to get this price up. But since we're doing another digital negotiation, I'll say, LS, you can jump in on this if it's what you want to do for your turn. You can actually be there to give Jim a +2 buff on skills if you successfully do a thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
yeah,
so you can buff
it,
Jim.
Let's go with it.
Yeah, you can buff Jim's rolls.
I'll buff Jim. I'll be his fucking number 2.
Help me out. Yeah. Help me out.
Yeah. Oh, fuck it. Yeah.
Let's go for it.
Yep. Right. Here we
I'm
go.
I'm reliable.
So, yeah. Jim, are you guys using LS's laptop so everybody can see, or are you going to use your Ubix specs so you can keep
it personal?
No, we're
going to use the laptop so everyone can look around.
Okay. Yeah.
It's my fucking laptop. You haven't asked me, you bastard.
LS's laptop starts beeping and humming, and all of a sudden, screen grab
best
behavior. And a window opens up and you see a man sitting there. He's
he's really sexy.
He's really rugged and looks like he's seen way too fucking much. Like, he's big dude, kind of scruffy looking. He's wearing like Oakley sunglasses, so you can't see his eyes.
But
you can see like the wrinkles and like the dirt and the scarring. And you can't really tell what's in the background. You can kind of like light is filtering in from somewhere. You really can't tell what all is going on.
Yeah.
And he kind of, like, you can see
the League of Legends clan.
He's kind of moving a little bit. Like, he's looking around. He's activated your laptop camera. He sees you. And he says, well, this isn't any more personal than the last time we met, but at least there aren't weapons involved. Where's your shooter at? He's kind of like moving around, trying to like look around the camera screen, trying to see Sassy.
My fears were true.
I
want to
ask him
to kill me.
I want to ask him how his wound is. I'm like, hey man, did that first aid hold up?
Going to kill
very
me.
Well. You have training.
Thanks.
Been
man.
Around the block a little bit.
Yeah, just a bit. Just a bit.
Well, that shows. That's a good sign. I'll be honest, a lot of what I saw out there wasn't necessarily that impressive, but
you guys are interesting
compared to the rest of the asshats trying to compete for a slice of buddy's pie. So yeah, why don't y'all take a crack at this, and I believe you might be able to trip and fall into this. But just in case you can't, I've got a little something for you. And as he says that, one of the latents walks up to you guys and sets a box down on your table at the bar.
And nice bomb.
He's gonna blow us up.
Go ahead and open it up.
Who's fucking opening this?
Are
up?
You kidding?
Who's opening it
up?
I'll open it up.
All right, well.
Me and Jim take like 50 steps back.
I'll open it up. I just pop it open.
It's a set of Ubix specs with GhoulNet for everybody else in the crew.
Fuck.
Yeah. So I spent all this money on the fucking laptop.
So yeah, he just he's pushing a gift spot right off the bat. Like, so are you accepting it or not?
Oh, that's a hard one.
How many bounties is that worth? How much are UB specs?
I think they're 2 or 3 bounty a pop plus the upgrades. So
Man, I'm happy with that. Fuck it, let's take the gear.
Yeah, we were going to go into this. Obviously, I'm not saying it's in character.
Are these fully upgraded?
No, just Ghoulnet.
They're optimized and they have Ghoulnet on them.
Well, that means that we're all in communication and we can work together. And we were going to go to Green Mountain for free. Obviously, I don't say that in front of him.
He's unsurreptitiously like trying to get across to you guys that maybe you should actually try to communicate with each other.
Yeah, and like when I went and said, I can't talk to my crew, can you message them for me? Was pretty shit.
Yeah, no, that was pretty eye-opening. So he played ESPN right off the bat.
I'm happy to take it
right now. You're accepting it? Okay.
Well, are we accepting it? Yes, great. Anybody saying no?
You want to shoot me?
All right, nope, you're taking it. All right, so yeah, that bumps him for this round of negotiations.
Pop him on.
What is your response? How do you want to
respond?
You want to try and persuade him? Like, what do you want to do? Like, you know, just throw me a persuasion check.
I want to try and persuade him that we're worth
right.
our money.
Give me your pitch.
He saw us on a bad day.
Oh, I've 2 persuasion as well, so I'm buffing him.
Are you going to buff him? All right, LS, I need you to give me a...
Okay, I'm just preparing myself to completely lie and say that we're a competent group.
Again.
Yep, again.
The usual line.
Yeah. It is, except you're dealing with somebody who actually lives outside the wall. Most of the people you've talked to. I do stress most.
Yeah.
So go ahead, just give me your persuasion check and give me your pitch on him.
So... Wait, shit, actually, I'm going to roll first, because that actually depends how I'm going to deliver
this
pitch. Yeah,
clever, actually.
I did really... I got 13 over 5, so I smashed it.
Awesome, kill it.
So,
I can be persuasive, man.
So what you saw of us at the bandit camp last time, that wasn't us at full force right there.
Oh? Is there somebody I can't see hanging out there?
But yeah, we're a more extended crew. You'll see some of them on the report for the mission.
All right. That's fine.
We got more to do. You didn't get a chance to see us in action.
All right. So, you've come up to add value, Jim, but he has already pushed down to hazard pay because that he's being a dick and gave you a gift spot. So, I need Skeebs. Who wants to get Jim a spot on the Gunslinger?
I will.
All right.
Is it the Gunslinger or is it his twin brother, the Gunslinger?
Uh-huh. Funny.
Lol.
Yeah, piss off the GM. Yeah, that's a great idea.
Gunslinger was his grandfather, who was a World War II fighter ace.
Oh, okay. Great.
How you tied that in. Well,
you like that?
Yeah, that's
yeah,
good.
Like that.
Criminality, because that seems to be my go-to.
Okay. All right, sell me on criminality. What are you doing?
Fuck you. I'm a criminal. I've had to steal shit to like survive and do other stuff and deal with the wrong type of people out in the woods. I'm going to steal from the levy hounds any kind of report on him.
Alright, that'll get you his tough spot. I'm not going to let you pick. That'll give you his
tough
spot.
Yeah, no, that's cool.
Alright, give me a roll. Can you pull it off?
That is the question. That is an 8-7. So just
all right, you do it. So you got the tough spot, one man national asset. The Gunslinger can pilot an MB-22 solo. He can make long range precision shots with no spotter. And apparently, he defies gravity, if this report's to be believed. He's been trained to the nth degree of military potential and can survive a nightmarish environment seemingly on his own. This begs the question of what is he fucking doing here?
The levy hounds are shit scared of him.
You're digging into his background. They haven't found much.
No, but that every
by
time
the fact that you're not finding much, you know that means there's secrets. So Jim, you can play that by pressing him on like his secretive nature. To get him to try and like pay you just to shut you up.
Yeah, who are you with and all that shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
So yeah. Alright, so next round. So the Gunslinger is like, well, that's fair. I appreciate the fact that y'all need the help and have it. You know, that's better than nothing out here. A lot of people are making do with not a whole lot. And it's a fairly simple job. Really just need y'all to reestablish the digital network coming out of that radio tower. I've got people I need to talk to. If you could patch me in, like, yeah, then obviously I'll pay. All right, so yeah, Jim. So yeah,
can
what
I,
are you gonna?
Can I press him for information while also debating with him about price, or is that going to count as a round where I'm not negotiating him up?
What exactly are you wanting to get here? Like, with so that,
I
want to
know. Really, what I want to know. I mean, this guy's got crazy intel on everything. He seems to know everything. what are we expecting to face there? What resistance?
Okay, I'll let you work the spot into that. That he's keeping secrets from. Okay.
Okay.
So, are you wanting to persuade with that one? Is that what you're
going
for? Yes,
I'm going to try and persuade, basically by hinting that nobody knows anything about him and that it'd be a lot of people would like to know something about him.
Okay.
But the information's valuable.
Yeah. How are you wanting to tie that in, though, to get information about the job?
I just want to talk... So, basically, I was thinking of going along the line of... we both know how important information is.
Okay.
Nobody
yeah,
seems
I dig
to have
that
any... You know...
You want to know something about what's going on. Like, why
yeah,
are you, why am
yeah.
I being asked to do this? Okay, that's cool. Yeah, give me the persuade check. Let's see what happens to you.
Oh, I passed just about. I've got 10 over 8.
Okay. Yeah, with a 10 over 8. Yeah, he's like, look, I'm paying you to friggin' handle shit, so just handle it. And that'll be that. So yeah, there's problems that I am currently involved with trying to deal with, some stuff that you really don't want to know about. And this is going to take too much time trying to sort out that mountain.
Multiple fronts.
Yeah. So yeah, basically, you know, if you're not catching, if that was a little too subtle, whatever. This isn't a simple walk up there and plug up and flip a switch job. There's something up there, and he knows it's up there. Which, thanks to Phil, you also know something's up there. So whatever it is, it's enough that it's going to take him too much time away from what he's trying to do.
Something serious.
Yeah. So you guys pushed up. Good job. You're now at labor. So that's black, red, and your breakpoints covered. So that's good. Yeah. You guys don't need that weighing down on top of you. He's going to try and read your spot, Jim. He's gonna go with squeamish because that's funny. With you with. Who wants to get Jim another spot? You're gonna need it if you want to resist him.
It's Rip.
Do we have to have talking? Things,
no, we
though?
Can.
If you can sell me on what you're doing, I'll give you the roll on it. But you need to sell me. You need to have a good idea for what you're doing and why you're doing it.
Okay.
Obviously,
I had
just
one
use
while
criminality.
We were talking.
To...
Give me a second.
Go for it.
I'm trying to remember what it was because I thought of it while you guys were talking.
Do you know what skill was evolving?
Yeah, it was the scavenging. I'm just trying to remember what I was gonna sell him on.
I'll give you a soft spot with that though.
Okay.
Fine.
So I roll.
Give me a roll.
7/6.
Yes, that's how that works.
Right. Oh yay!
So yeah, while you're scavenging around, you actually found a picture.
Ooh, yeah.
From the early days of the war. And it's almost like a kind of a PR propaganda type thing. But it was in a house that you could tell had kids in it. And yeah, you now see the face on it. That's his, now that you're looking at it. He's in this picture.
He's here before.
You know, yeah, carrying kids out of, he can't really tell where the hotspot is. Like, I mean, you've been all over Chernarus, but like so much of it's just forested terrain,
yeah.
You know, with little tiny villages, right. You know, just scattered throughout it. You're not entirely sure where, but like, yeah, he clearly got people out of some stuff. So you got the soft spot. I've got you 6. Gunslinger is the last of his kind, at least as far as he knows. The surviving member of his unit, he doesn't hold much trust in the authoritarianism of the hero forces, but he isn't about to become a murderous leech like the bandits. Loyalty's a hard element to maintain in the best of circumstances. Being alone in a wasteland as hostile as Chernarus has become makes it an impossibility. So yeah, if you can, Jim, if you can demonstrate something about brotherhood or... some other aspect to kind of show that there's something for him to believe in you and actually like hold some loyalty to you. Yeah, that would allow you to push him up.
Show we're something different from the others.
Right. So yeah. I think this guy is pretty. I know this guy is a bit elitist in terms of the skills, but actually, I'm gonna be a bit more vulnerable here. I'm gonna be open about. Obviously, he's fucking seen firsthand that some members of the group fuck up. And you know what? We're clever enough to know that we could just fucking drop that person and get someone more reliable.
And no, that's the opposite direction of where you want
to
go.
No, but I'm saying we could. But of course, we're not going
but
to because we're
yeah, okay. He's part of the group.
I'm sorry.
We could easily sell him off, but no, we don't do that.
I get what he's saying. My bad. I like that, Jim. Go ahead. And then if you want, you can give me a deception roll to try and counter him using your spot of squeamish.
Okay, perfect. Right.
Give me the deception check first, actually, because he's like, look,
come on, Jim.
I saw you guys out there. You guys had firepower, but you weren't really using it. And like, you just kind
of don't tell him that none of us can drive.
We can now.
I mean,
yeah. My deception
There's some bad shit out there.
My deception check is unfortunately a critical failure.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
He reads straight through you, man.
Jim, would you like to spend a will to negate that down to just a failure?
I only have one will point left and I don't want to die, so no.
He does see through you. And he's gonna negate your push. So
what's his response?
But since he's sitting there calling you, and since you crit failed, I'm gonna say it, and he saw right through you. I'll give you a will point for flinching there. Like,
okay, cool.
On the squeamish. So that's how that's gonna play out. So yeah, that's not good. He pushed you way down. Way down. So we're going into round four. You guys, you need spots. You need to push him back fast.
Give me something, guys.
Who hasn't gone yet?
He's gonna get yours. He's gonna get Hustler. He's gonna get that.
Because I did a crit fail, did that mean I also didn't have a chance to try and push it up?
Yeah, I'm gonna say he undercut it. He saw right through what. Yeah, he made you flinch. Yeah, you didn't even get a chance to respond.
Fucking prepared as well.
Yeah,
unlucky man.
It happens. Yep, it happens. Like, the good news is, if you pass your leadership check, you'll still get full value at this point. Okay, guys, here's your choices. You guys can get weak spot. You guys haven't gotten his weak spot yet, so you could push for a spot, try and push up two, and Jim can try another deception chest to negate his getting a spot. Or you guys could try and manipulate the price and hope Jim passes his leadership test.
I want to go for the spot.
Okay.
But LSS group, guys.
But
so
someone else has
got to
go.
Okay, but when does LS is boosted?
So how does the altering of the price work?
All right, so the ultimate price is you got to give me some sort of scheme where you're to make you like look better that the price will go up. You'll roll. If you succeed, the price will go up your black dice. Unless you crit succeed, then it'll just go up a flat 11. That's how price manipulation works. So if you guys did that, your best case scenario is you would push your price total up to 25 total. Not great. So you could do that, or you could try and push him back up. Jim could try another deception chest. You could maybe push him back up to labor. That'd be your best case scenario.
I think we should go after the black, red,
and break point.
But that's down to you guys.
Also, not doing the price manipulation you're recommending is not the best idea.
Well, they both have advantages and disadvantages. I mean, yeah, if you fuck up, fuck ups are gonna bite you here. So you know, it's kind of a, they're both at this point they're both real big risks since you had a crit fail that just shoved you all the way down. That was unfortunate, but I mean, you guys have been doing really good on negotiations, so you're bound to hit it sooner or later.
Yeah. I think we go over the point, just because we
like... Oh, you want to go for the weak spot?
That's what I would say, but no one else is giving their input, so what are you guys doing?
Sounds good.
Yeah, cool. Fuck it, let's do
Can
it.
Can I try, impress him?
It's not you.
How are you going to fucking impress him?
You've just been on screen, instantly.
The only one left. So it has to
LS can do it too.
I thought LS was boosting.
Give me a foresight check. Whoever wants to go, I'll take a foresight check.
Yeah.
To the good
crit
foresight.
Success.
Wow, you got really good foresight.
All right. So that will negate his. Well done. So you got his weak spot. I've got it. Being competent in a crowded field tends to make one overconfident and resentful. The gunslinger's been alone a long time. As such, he tends to assume the lead on any situation he finds himself involved in. This would grow tiresome in a normal life where self-care and support structures are plentiful and availability. Out here, it's a drain few could survive. He's managed to keep himself together so far, but every new mission is another mess for him to get caught out in. So you can press this either with sympathy or coercion to force him to face his ego. I'll let you make the call, Jim, but you've already succeeded. So just give me a role play on this one. He was about to give you shit for being a skeevy fuck, a hustler.
Whatever, man. I don't care. I know I'm a hustler, really. Whatever, who cares? I'm a fucking gypsy, you know. Who gives a shit? I've got a little gypsy kid I'm training up to be Gypsy Robin. You know.
He cocks his head a little bit.
I understand that every time you go out there, every time you go on a mission, something can go wrong. Every time you fucking kill a bunch of people, you feel a bit different inside, you know. I understand that. And I know why you need us to go take this out for you, and we can go do it for you.
All right, that works. Yeah, he doesn't say anything. He doesn't move. He's just a stone wall staring at you. Give me a leadership test, Jim. Well done.
Shit off, dude.
Yep.
Yeah, smash it. 13.5.
All right, so that bumps you up to hazard pay. That is black plus red plus breakpoint plus one bounty per taker per leg.
Fucking saved. Nicely done, LS. Wow.
Fucking hell.
Way to
Jim.
Go,
what did you say that was? 13 to what, Jim?
5.
13 to 5? All right.
Jesus Christ. Mostly done, LS and Jim. That was a fucking saved our asses.
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, that will net you guys. All right, so your breakpoint, we won't even count. It's just you guys know that's paid, so you guys don't have to worry about it. So that will net you guys 26 bounty before anything else. Pretty you nice. Guys do. Two legs. You guys have two legs.
Was that 24, Jay?
It's 6 plus 8 plus 10. So okay. 26 total.
Can I do
something? No, oh. Sorry. 6 plus, you're right, 24. My bad. I don't know what the fuck's wrong with me. My math just went.
yeah,
it is 24. Thank
can I do something that might be unorthodox if I'm allowed to do it? Because LS checked originally on his network check to see what group's free agents were about.
Uh-huh.
Can he name some off?
To what end?
I just want to see if any free agents are a part of a certain group of people.
Well, okay. Certain group of people, yes.
You know what I'm on about?
Give me a persuasion check.
Persuasion check. I ain't got persuasion.
Or, do you have it?
No, negative.
No?
Awareness?
Shit, do you have researching now?
Nope. Got foresight.
Networking.
No networking. Got the in talkie skills, I've got foresight and deception.
Give me criminality then. Nah, give me criminality. Oh. Yeah. You're asking him for this information?
Well, no, because LS did the search, didn't he, when we were thinking about getting the...
Oh, okay, so you want this. This is after negotiations.
Yeah, this has nothing to do with negotiations.
All right, this will be... Yeah, we'll get there in a second. All right, so So the gunslinger's like, well, you got your UBIC specs. I would hope you'd use them, but sell them, talk them if you want. It's your fucking... your funeral.
Don't you want to be,
give him a quick salute.
The whole group.
I'll give him a quick salute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He says, so... I assume you know where Green Mountain is. If you don't, ping. He pings the computer on the GPS to show you where it is. He's like, yeah, here is the module. He shows you a diagram of what needs to be. He's like, if you activate that, I'll be able to wirelessly connect because this, they were trying to modernize it mid-war, but this is a really popular spot to fight over for obvious reasons. So it should still be there. And if it is, yeah, it should be fairly straightforward if you have somebody competent with tech and skills to wire that up. And watch your six. He clicks off. You regain control of your laptop. So yeah.
Yep.
Does anybody want to do it? Obviously Phil's about to make a roll, but does anybody else want to do anything to research the job before you head out?
I mean, I got research skills.
I mean, I want to know. Can I just go to the Leighton Bar and just hang out? Because I basically want to. We've been hearing, you know, number one, I always want an excuse to go to the Leighton Bar.
Yeah, you do like the Leighton Bar for some reason.
Number two,
they're good people.
Everyone. everyone there just talks shit, and we know that there's like rumors about Green Mountain, but we don't really know what they are.
What do you mean they all talk shit?
Okay, I'm gonna make you give me two checks on that one, Jim. But yeah, okay, I'll let you have that. Yeah. But first, I want Phil to give me his criminality check.
Roger that. I am rolling.
Four.
Well, that's a fail. All
right. Yeah, I mean,
just a load of
there's lots of names, rumors. Lots names. Of rumors. Yeah, nothing sounds familiar.
Yeah, fair enough.
All right. You could spend a will on it if you want to flip that.
I've only got one at the moment, so I'm in the gym school of thought of saving it for a rainy day.
Hey, I get it. I totally get it. Yeah. I will give you a will point though for that, even for failing, because you did advance a spot.
Cool.
I'll give you credit for that.
Thanks, man.
Jim, give me an awareness test. No, networking. No, give me an awareness, because networking you auto win. I want you to actually have to roll for this. Give me awareness.
Awareness? Okay. Mm-hmm. What's my bonus on awareness?
You got your character sheet.
Yeah, no, I'm checking. It's just one, but I win. It's 8-4.
All right, great. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you hear them talking. They're telling the ghost stories. So give me a sensitivity check to see if you can sort out what's true and what's bullshit.
My sensitivity is plus 2, and a scratch through 9-8.
All right. Yeah. So ghost stories. That's what these tend to be, ghost stories. Yeah, like people will go up there, they hear stuff, maybe they see stuff. There's been tons of tales about people disappearing over the years. That's not really quantifiable though. Like, you do hear one latent who's telling about he got turned on Green Mountain. And yeah, he said there's something up there that the Blight seems drawn to. Doesn't really understand, but he got attacked by vectors up there. But you know, Green Mountain's a fairly decent scrap away from Zelina, or you know, even Paul Grevka. Doesn't seem likely vectors would just wander up there. Like, they tend to like be constantly on the move, tracking anything hot that could be eaten, like because they're still fairly cognitively active compared
if
to
if I buy this
zombie.
Guy a drink, can I try and persuade him to talk to me more?
Nah, he's drunk off his ass.
He's drunk as fuck already.
He's
okay,
drunk
cool,
as fuck
cool.
So anybody else want to do any research on the job? Jim's heard some rumors that he's been able to confirm are at least true as far as the person who said them are. Someone can give me research.
Anybody got any research?
I'll do research.
All right, burn a charge off of you, big specs.
Suppose I'm going to find some use for these specs.
you already had a pair of specs. So
yeah, yours are upgraded as well, aren't
you? Yeah, you've got a full upgraded set.
No, I know, but I haven't used them yet. This is the first time. Yeah, you get 10 over 6.
Okay. So, the radar station was built by the Russians way, way back in the day, the antenna. And it was a small military outpost. Like, it's a semi-fortified compound from what you can tell. Like, it had walls and lockable gate, razor wire around the top. Looked like a basic, little military station. But didn't matter. It's off the beaten path. But there were lots of technical difficulties. Like, there's lots of reports of repairmen going there. Like, something's weird about that place. And when the war broke out, neither NATO nor the Russian Federation could hold it. They lost a lot of men trying to take that place, because obviously it was important to keep communications open, propaganda, psyops, and just, general, like, keep the news flowing around the area. But it went down pretty fast, never came back up. So you got a basic layout of the compound though, so you know the compound.
Yeah, apparently it's been like it since.
How long are vectors active for again?
2 weeks.
2 or 3 weeks.
Okay, cool.
You don't want
traitors. Traitors avoid it, people
everybody
don't
avoids it.
Nobody goes through there. Like, it's just not a place you go. There's no villages. There's no villages that close to it. Most of them, Paul Grevka and Zelina are the closest actual towns. Well, Zelino's a city. Zelino crawls because you were just there. You don't know much about Paul Grevka. You haven't really been through there very much. So,
cool.
All right. Everybody ready to go?
I'm really rough.
No.
Come on,
are you taking out any of your war assets?
Of course, we're taking out the fucking... We're taking out... We've got a Humvee now, no?
Are we going to roll on the Humvee? I don't think it's a good idea if, because we don't know what we're up against. And we don't know what we're up against.
I kind of like the idea of sneaking in and scoping it out first, but that's just
Jim, I will tell you, the guy told you when he got turned. He's been turned for a few months. So yeah, you know those vectors are not active that he got attacked by. Yeah.
Okay, all right, well, it's only two legs. All right, whatever.
We'll go quiet.
We're going to walk in a tight formation, lads.
We've got bikes. All right. We'll bike it.
Yeah, you guys have bikes?
Yeah, we can bike it.
No, I don't have a bike.
Well, get on the back of one of them. A few of us are going to have to double up.
All right, leg one. You don't burn rations, because I believe that's what bikes do for you. Let me double check that. But I believe they skip leg as far as the expenditure of rations. Oh, there's stats for ATVs. Dare you motherfuckers to get an ATV.
No, I still want to look at it and it'll do 20 backflips and crash into a house.
Okay. yeah, so you guys, everybody that's riding a bike, give me an athletics check.
Athletics check. So that is...
Slinger.
Yeah.
I got a 10-10 again.
Crit success.
I'm not going to lie, I was just going to say I'm riding with LS because I don't want to ride with Alex because he's a bastard and he doesn't believe in my
games. Well, LS gets to tell me, since you said that after he rolled a crit, I want to know, LS, who's riding with you? Is it Gray?
Have I got to take Gray? Is there no one?
You have to take somebody. Well, you have to take somebody.
No, there's no one. All Gray. No one all Gray.
Oh, okay. So Gray's riding with Alex then. You don't have to take anybody, LS. You can be by yourself.
Oh, and he can ride with Jim.
He can.
Okay. Yeah, cool. You're riding with Jim.
Okay. Jim?
Are you joking?
Nope.
Huate and Spygon.
12-1.
All right. Spygon's good. Huate.
Oh, I tank it. 3-9.
Fuck you, long shots.
Yeah, you guys are biking through the open fields, heading southwest out of Starry. Yeah. Not really near anything. But yeah, a rifle shot cracks past Jim and Sassy's heads.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Self control check.
That was high powered. You've heard those shots before from George's gun.
There's gunslinger.
Self control for you two.
Yep. They're already shooting at me.
Yeah, I'm all good.
That's still
I'm
a stress.
Good. Okay.
That's one stress. It's still a rifle shot going past your head. Yeah. So what do you guys do? You guys have lagged behind and you were out in the open when the round came past.
Serpentine, for the love of God. I can't
serpentine on the bike. It's real life physics now.
Slowly serpentine.
I will give you another athletics check to try and get out of the danger zone. Or you guys could pull over and try and ascertain the shooter and deal with them.
I think we just want to fucking get the fuck out of here.
Okay, give me another athletics check.
I've got a mission to go to. I'm just going to try and power it.
Make sure you're spending rations, Jim. You spent one for the first one.
Oh, yeah.
Just about passed.
But you did not?
No, I did.
He just passed.
Okay, all right. You do make it to the next tree line where the rest of the group is waiting for you guys, looking concerned.
He went
Is everybody all right? Is everybody
lads,
good?
Everyone's
let's keep
okay.
moving. Let's keep
no
moving.
Let's, yeah, we're just going to keep going. We're here. Just going to go fucking take this place. So let's go. Come on.
Let's go.
Sassy, give me an awareness check.
Oh, God.
Well, if we're all there, can we all aware? Can't we all be aware?
What? Nope, you cannot. You were not there.
I got it. 9/5.
I'm not talking to you. You weren't there. Yeah, okay. you guys booked it. You've been shooting long enough. You can kind of like you figured out how to kind of like vector off of snap hisses. That was coming from Cabanino. That's O4V's base.
Oh, for fuck's sake! We just had a great fucking O4V.
Yeah.
Already.
Yep.
They heard about you guys cracking into their base.
We didn't crack into shit.
No, did you?
It was those seals guys.
We got better.
They heard differently. So
whoever it was, they were wrong.
All right, next leg. Athletics text, everybody.
9-5.
Okay, you're good. Bill, Jim.
I probably could have got away with taking Adam.
13-3.
Okay.
Failed horribly.
Failed again. You guys are going through Pogrevka. It's a small, kind of quaint little village. You know, everybody's just kind of, it is a village, so, you know, that tends to be where casualties tend to
chill out,
tend to conglomerate. And Huate and Sassy, do
yes.
either of you guys have any, do any of your characters have any, like, kind of religious things?
No.
Nope. No? Okay. So yeah, it's, you don't really care about the Orthodox priest standing in the middle of the road, as far as like that's some sort of like, you know,
fine or something.
Yeah, it's not like a sin against God or anything. But when he screams, "Holy Mother of God, kill me!"
Oh shit!
Yeah.
Oh
that's,
fuck.
That's bad.
That's real bad.
Control test.
Oh, so I really need to get off your bike. but not right now.
Are we out of shooting range now?
Yeah.
Of Cabanino? Yeah, yeah. You're Pokrovka. Yeah, you're,
okay,
you're
okay.
The terrain rolls downwards, so they have no line of sight on you.
Oh,
yeah.
Fuck, lads. We might have to dismount and take this fucker down.
They're not with us,
trying to rush past it.
How those self-control tests go, guys?
Yeah, self-control first, guys.
Crit success.
9/9 after my stats, so not a crit fail, but a failure indeed.
All right, Jim, give me one more athletic. I'll give you one last chance to get out of this one. Give
Come
me
on, Jim.
12-2.
All right, you book it. He's chasing you, but like you're just pedal, and he loses sight of you as you whip it over the hill.
Fucking power out. That's it.
Bang out of there into the tree line. So good job. Bikes paid off. You guys more or less got out of those situations unmolested. You guys have approached Green Mountain from the east northeast, where you guys should know that area pretty well. Where are you hopping off? There's the tree line that runs out from the main highway.
Yeah.
You could jump off there. You could ride up the dirt track right straight up to the radio station.
The dirt track with all like the hedges and the trees along it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The like little scrub all the way. I want to get off the bike where it hits the road and then start climbing, using the foliage to get up towards the
okay.
base.
I sure. agree.
Yeah, that'll work. All right, so yeah, you guys can hop off. You want to make stealth? You want to stealth it? Or
yeah,
you
I want to stealth it.
Oh, definitely.
All right, everybody give me stealth checks.
9/1.
Okay.
Oh, 9/1 as well.
6/7.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Rip and Gray.
9/3.
Nice. Okay. Ripley?
10/6.
Long shots.
Ally.
Give me an Hello. Athletics check. You really want to succeed this one.
Crit fail.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Take 8 killing to zone 5.
Fucking hell, what did you just get hit by?
I don't fucking know. Hang on, that's nearly the arms gone.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
You got hit
Can
hard,
I
man.
Ranger first aid?
Hello? Well, we're out in
the... That's the thing. You guys were all snelping up. You didn't hear the gunshot that hit him. So, LS, what are you doing now? You've just been shot in the arm.
Probably fucking rolling around on the floor.
Are you?
Pain.
Yeah? Are you,
Pretty much how it fucking goes when you get shot
Yeah,
in
are you going out to the team, or are you, you trying to clamp down on it?
You know what? I'm taking one for the team. I'm trying to fucking
keep
bite
shut.
And just yeah. grin and bear right. to
cool.
try
Give
and
me a self-control
sure
test. You just got fucking shot.
I know, right?
I fully know I just got shot.
Oh.
10/8. Okay.
Yeah.
It's one trauma. You got shot in the arm. That hurt. That hurt bad.
What do you mean it fucking hurt? Of course it fucking hurt. Cool,
and,
that,
and on top
over.
Of that, you're spewing your black latent blood all over the place, so that's a danger
yeah,
to everything
yeah.
and anyone that comes near you. yeah. So, okay. So, yeah, you guys keep moving up the tree line. Are you guys want to give me another stealth test? Make it up to the
I'll
top
roll
of the ridge?
Another stealth test.
All right, give
sure,
me another stealth test. Make
go.
It up to the top of the ridge.
Uh-oh.
Critical success.
All right, I'll say your crit success can save Ripley's failure.
Yes.
Okay.
Huate and Sassy.
Crit success!
All right.
Yeah, 5/1. Pass.
Okay, okay. We'll Gray, with just... your crit success, I'll say you caught it. You caught the cough of the shot. And you look back and see long shots on the ground. Yeah. Give me a self-control test, Gray.
For being...
With success, my fucking ass. Jesus. Three over two.
So.
All right.
Great, that one.
All right, so yeah, you guys are under fire, but you've been under fire before, so it's fine. You gonna holler at the crew to tell them Longshot just got shot?
Yes.
So yeah, everybody.
I'm heading back with my first aid.
Okay, self-control test first for everybody because you're under fire.
Yeah. Can I call out the Ripley?
I thought we were fine with that. I thought we were fine with being under fire. What happened?
Ripley's on Ubix, right?
Well. You guys didn't hear it, though. That's the problem. You didn't hear it.
We can't react. We just didn't hear it, so we can't react.
Yeah. I'm just going to say over Ubix backs, Ripley, you can't save him. He's
so
spewing blight everywhere.
That was suppressed.
What?
It was suppressed.
He's spewing. He's literally bleeding blight. You can't touch him.
You'll get infected.
Can try. It's just going to go real bad
if you fuck it up.
Yeah. You can try.
Well... That makes me nervous. I don't understand.
That's the whole point.
That should make
right,
you nervous.
Long shots
I want
so he's basically a walking zombie.
Slinger.
No, he's a... All zombies walk. He is a...
You know what I mean? He's an alive, fully functioning human
being. He's a cognitive zombie. He's been infected with the blight. He has a cold strain in him, but it did not take over his cognitive abilities. So he's still... Long shots the person inhabiting a zombie body, basically.
So if you get his blood on you...
You get his blood on you, you're going to turn vector.
I want to try and go for a foresight check, just so then I can make the group aware.
Yeah, give it to me.
7-1.
Okay, you even vectored the shot. It came from the... All right, so the tree line kind of hooks... With the open face of the hook facing directly north, right? Does everybody who has the map up kind of see what I'm talking about?
No,
there's a tree stand there. There's a tree stand there, if that helps you orient on your maps. The shot came from there.
Okay.
LS knows this.
I did my self-control test and passed.
Okay, you're fine. Yeah. You guys
I did my self-control test and had a critical failure. Sorry.
No, yeah. You're good. Yeah.
I've had good rolls today.
You crack in stress, Ripley. You may fight, you may flee, or you may freeze. Which would you like to do?
Well, it's me. I'm going to flee.
Okay, cool.
Gray, never crit success again.
Do what?
Literally the worst crit success.
Oh, no, it's. I don't know how it's.
I could do that.
I don't know how it bears so far in the arse.
I mean, it's worked out okay. LS is relayed to you where the shooter is. The rest of you guys are cool. You now know you're under fire and where it is. Just so happened your noob who hasn't actually gone out in the field with you has never been shot at before. At least, you know, not in this way. So, yeah, she's having a hard time with it. And she's now sprinting down through the open field. Away. Toward Bukovo.
So what's the situation? She's running. LS, is LS okay now, or what's going on? Is he still
spraying blood? Nah, he's still laying there bleeding. I mean, he laid his position of the shooter to you, but he's still laying there bleeding out.
Can I throw him bandages on the way back?
Nope, you're one track running now. You're shitting your pants.
Searching with him, taking control of me.
So
the shooter just missed you, Ripley, so that's good. Didn't hit you. Yeah. The hostile is still active, people.
So we're in combat now, I guess.
You're heading towards Bukovo.
So are we initiative now?
Yeah.
I kind of just want to throw my hawk into the air.
Yeah. Okay, throw the hawk in the air, Jim.
All right, I'm going to do a roll for that.
I need animal handling.
Come on, Jim.
Oh, fucking fail. Christ's sake.
Unlucky, man.
Give me another self-control test, Jim. Your hawk just got shot out of the sky.
What?
My hawk got shot.
What?
Yeah.
Why did it get shot? What?
Because it was fail.
Yeah, was it a fucking crit fail?
Nope, he failed. That gave the opportunity to your opponent.
Fucking
hell.
I made the shot.
How did we last one in?
I passed the check, but I'm just frozen for a turn. I've got to be frozen.
No,
because
that would be a crack. You didn't crack. You do take one to detachment. The hawk just got shot. It's not dead, though.
Oh my God.
It's not dead. It's just shot.
But he doesn't know it's not dead.
Huh?
How does he know it's not dead?
He's just seen it get blown out of the sky.
I mean, it's still screaming as it's falling.
Oh, God.
Slinger, all I sight. All I sight is game.
Master, you've forsaken me.
Slinger, all I sight here is Game of Thrones.
Oh yeah.
All right.
Right.
Yeah, I can't only take one detachment from that.
That's fucking that's horrifying.
Didn't you pass?
Yeah, but
to the character, it's fucking devastating.
I mean, it is devastating, but you pass, so it's one detachment. Okay. Like, you didn't pass it. You didn't crit fail, you didn't crit succeed.
Sure.
If you crit failed, you crack. Definitely off that.
I don't know.
But yeah, you succeeded, so it is an animal at the end of the day. It's your animal, and you want it back.
It's his best friend!
Alright. What's your soft spot, Jim?
Animals and children.
He's fucking traumatized.
Yeah, I want a will point.
Open fire on the tree line with your grenade launcher.
Oh yeah, holy shit.
I've got a grenade launcher.
I'm just gonna fucking pull this thing out. I'm just gonna be like, no one shoots my fucking horn.
So it's gonna take you an action to reload it. You open fire. Give me a shoot chest. I'll see if you can succeed and maybe get a lucky hit.
Come on.
I fail horribly.
Let's go away.
No, I get like a 2.
Just
two
goes
eight.
Flying into the woods, just blows up nothing.
Probably some suppression, they're at least fucking scared. Someone's scared.
Possibly. I don't know who it is.
You said you failed, right?
Yeah, standard fail.
Oh, it's still a fail, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, nah, that's... I mean, sure, you could think that.
Yeah, but they don't. they're suppressed.
I'll just think it so I feel better.
Slinger. I have a question.
Okay, send it to me.
As to what I can do.
Uh-huh.
I want to pull my laptop out of my bag.
Okay. And?
I want to get straight on the fucking phone to Gunslinger.
No! No, not at all!
I'm bleeding out. I'm bleeding out.
Yeah, you don't get on a laptop!
You've been given money. This is where you want to go with this.
I want to network up with some PMCs.
Okay, and?
I want to be like fucking distress level cool. Like, we need like a distress beacon out there.
No, we don't. Oh my god.
Someone needs to come help us. No.
The melodrama is real. Stop it, guys.
One of them's fucking.
You guys are
members.
Now all ghoul netted in together. I'll give y'all chances to persuade him not to do this.
I will try and persuade him not to, but I've got nothing to
persuade.
Okay,
give me a roll. Give me the roll.
I'm counter rolling this.
Yeah, you're going to counter roll with 4 seconds.
7-4.
Okay, LS.
Fuck.
Yeah.
7-8.
All right. Yeah. Phil succeeds in telling you to calm down.
Yeah.
Phil, are you going back to get him?
Oh my god, I didn't want to, but now he's like about to ruin the whole
he's
mission.
Yeah,
I guess I am. I guess I'll go back out into the fucking
Jim's
shooting range.
Suppression fire, and that is the most crucial element.
Loose term suppression fire.
Well, you know, suppressing the forest in general.
Right,
Gray,
so
what are you doing, Gray?
Are the grenades actually making it to the opposite tree line?
What's happening, Sassy? What is Sassy doing?
Can I ask at this point,
your will point?
We...
Do you want your usual will point?
I'm considering a will point, to be honest.
Adam, if you don't shoot this motherfucker, right?
I will shoot him, but I see a lovely bush in the distance and it looks really good. Yes, I want a beautiful sight line on this hook.
Great.
You absolute cuck.
Take your will point.
Yep.
Why
I'll come back
you...
to you in a minute. Rest of you guys. Initiative time. Give me speed checks. Take your...
Crit success on my speed.
Oh, 11-3.
I just need the black plus your speed.
11 then.
Okay.
10.
But then it's
wrong band crit success.
Yeah.
That's shit then.
Yeah.
What is it?
Oh, it's like 4.
Yeah. Have you got add your speed? Have you got any speed?
Yeah, that is with my speed.
Fucking hell.
Double deuces. LS, what was yours?
10.
10?
11. I'm so glad that it was only the black because I got a crit fail.
Phil, what was yours?
11.
I was getting so close to crying.
You already are! I'm about to tell you to calm it fucking down, mate!
Gray?
I'm crying black bile at the minute.
Gray?
Yes?
What? I need your initiative.
Oh, even 9. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You're still in the fight.
So yes, bush boy.
It's the number plus my speed, that means it's 6.
Okay, great. Love it.
Oh, I keep forgetting to add the plus part, so mine was 13.
Okay.
Jesus.
Wow. Nicely done, Rip.
You are fucking...
Ripley's the Flash.
Wow.
Yeah, she's the Flash running the wrong way at the moment.
Running away. Yeah, so we're going to skip you, Ripley. Right, you're gonna be out this turn. I'm going to say you make it to the tree line at Kustreak. Do you see that on the map? You see what I'm talking about? Yes, you.
Okay.
It's the mountainside opposite Green Mountain to the southeast.
That's far away did she get?
Yes.
Wow.
She fucking moved. Yeah.
She fucking flew.
I mean, she was already at max speed. That's the thing. We had to like accelerate, but she was already at max Mach 4.
They're already
at that
basically
point.
Fucking Mach 1.
Basically. All right. Spygon.
I guess I'm getting to LS and medicing him up.
You running? You stealthing?
Is there any point of stealthing now? Because they got eyes on him.
It'll take you 2 stealth tests to get there, but you won't get shot at.
Okay, I will try and stealth.
Alright, give me stealth
test. So that's 12 to 3.
Alright, you made your first one. Log shots. What are you doing down there?
I don't fucking know. Try not to spew bile in Phil's face.
Where have you been shot?
In the arm, innit?
Got shot in the arm. I'll say you
I've got
can
nothing left.
Give me a computer tech chest, Ella.
I can't just
give
you
a check.
I got a 6
whining.
To a 10.
6 to 10? Yep. I
can't
that
even
sucks.
Use Google.
Yep, that sucks. Cray.
Yes.
Give me an awareness test.
Ooh. Baby. Yeah. He's done it. He's only gone a 10 and 3.
Okay. As you're moving towards your bush, you see her.
Her?
Yeah.
It's
quiet from Metal Gear Solid 5.
She's,
I was more one for Sniper Wolf, but okay.
It's a hind D.
A hind D.
We're not doing this. We've done this in DayZ before. We're not doing it again.
What's a Russian gunship doing here?
You're gonna die. Right now.
A hind D is literally about to fall on you.
She's, yeah. She's in a, like, a blue dress. Kind of like, you know, pretty traditional for the area.
Yeah.
Just kind of standing there looking at you.
How far away is she?
About 10 feet.
Fuck it out.
Wow, she close.
She is real close.
Yeah. And, yeah, she's just looking at you.
Okay.
Hang on a second. I didn't bring this up.
And you're looking at her, and she bites her lip.
But she's a zombie, so it's not.
No, I misread that. She bites your lip.
Yeah. And then she starts to lead closer to you.
I told you.
And she says, "Pajalista, ubemin your bog." And then she jumps on you. Give me a resistance check.
Oh my god.
What?
Oh my god.
That's not where
stop
I seen that going.
Stop
what the fuck?
Super nightmares, Jesus Christ.
Zed picks their dads.
Give me a resistance check, Greg.
I've already done it. It's 11 over 1.
Alright, well, she doesn't bite you. But she's on top of you. We'll come back to you.
He's on top of you already. You're fast.
Wait, it's a zombie?
It's a vector. Yeah.
We're all dead. Fucking dead.
Right. So where are the rest of us in all of it? I'm last. I'm in the back.
Yeah, it's your turn now.
You weren't lying.
It's my
dead.
Turn now.
What's that? Yeah, it is your turn to go.
So I'm like kind of running up to this. I'm like near
no,
Adam.
You are okay. So
no,
Spygon is moving down the tree line towards LS's position.
Okay.
Stepping it up.
Disappeared. God knows where. You can still see Ripley running towards the mountain across the way from you, and your grenade launcher's empty. You're just kind of sitting there. So what do you want to do?
Fuck, I guess I'm going to run after Bill and Longshots to try and keep some cohesion going.
Okay.
So I'm going to have Ubik specs to fucking help me.
You do not have Ubik specs in Ghoulnet, so you can... Reload and get
can I shout at him for a second? Like,
oh, okay. You know what? I just want to reload.
I'm like, okay, suppress that tree line.
Okay.
Can I be screaming over Ghoulnet to fucking help me? I've got a vector on me.
Do you want to do that, Gray? Do you want to do that?
Don't do that, Gray. Please.
Please do it. Please
just save yourself, man.
It's like, don't be using that voice.
Do you know what is going to happen? This happens every time we do this.
Gray.
You know what is happening.
Great. Were you broadcasting? Like, was your did you have your Ubik specs on?
No,
I don't think so.
You didn't actually have them on?
Well, I don't think they were live because I haven't used
No, if you have them on, they're live. That's how GhoulNet works.
Oh.
Do you have them on?
Fuck it, I had them on.
Why would you be running around with them on?
You just see a bloody mouth. Snapping.
That's 12 to 2.
Okay, you're fine. Fucking idiot shouldn't have wandered off. Got bigger problems right now.
Shouldn't have had him on in the first place.
I knew there was something about it. I shouldn't have listened.
Wait, this happens every time. I don't understand how you forget.
Long shots. How was your self-control test?
9 to 2.
Okay, you're fine. Jim?
You got your arm.
Thanks.
10 to 9.
All right, you're fine, too. Oh. Yeah. That's a problem, but so is the actual shooting at you right now.
Kill quiet.
Noelle, the female was the zombie, not the sniper.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Spygon. Need another stealth test.
Stealth test is... I've got 3 plus... So you're 7 to 3. So
you
pass.
All right, yeah, you make it to LS. Yeah. And, yeah, I'll even say since you succeeded by 3, you can give me a medi check. Be careful on that one, because you don't want to get infected.
So that is a 97.
All right. So, yeah.
Jesus.
You can, with a 97, you can convert all the killing to stun.
Killing to stun. Fix your arm.
Oh. Oh. Fuck for that.
Right. Yeah. We need to move. So.
Ripley, we're back to the top of the order. I need you to give me a self-control test really quick.
Okay.
Jesus Christ.
You're watching Sassy get mauled by a vector on live video footage.
As you run at full speed.
A critical success.
Yes! Everybody doesn't give a shit about Grey being eaten.
No one gives a shit about
Why
Grey.
Is that? What?
Yeah, with a crit success, I'll say you just where you went running off to is the same area where Grey is, so you actually see where he is. You could actually go help him.
Please.
Don't do it.
Long range rifle, and I'm going to.
Oh god, don't do it.
This talk like the, you know.
Alright, that's firing into melee.
You could
so
hit Grey and kill him.
Is bad. Yep. Failure
oh,
is bad.
Oh, this could be great.
Long shot to stop it!
how confident you feeling,
so
Rip?
Yeah, if you want to do this, though, Ripley, give me a shoot check.
Okay,
okay,
I'm
cool.
Just going to use the one charge.
Alright, that's your choice.
Oh,
so
she's
you're
brave.
Adding two.
She's brave.
Oh my god, I'm gonna die.
This is a hard shot.
And then I'm adding 2.
Yep.
And my roll is 7-6.
Bloody hell, that was a freaking close one, Greg.
Yeah, that was close.
I don't care. I saved
that. No, no, you did.
You
did,
Greg.
Yeah, you did.
Fact. You shot a vector.
Vector's a very strong Ripley.
Yeah.
Yeah. You shot a vector. So you did 7 killing to its right arm. It's still able to use that arm. Moving
but
on.
I have to shoot again.
Ripley, you should have used more charges.
Log shots.
Yes.
What you doing?
Your arms.
Boy patched you up. Still under the scope of a deadly sniper, as far as you know. What do you want to do?
Hide behind Phil.
He can't see me, so you can't hide behind me because I'm not there.
Yeah, hide.
Are you going up into the forest or back down towards the road?
Yeah.
So the forest takes me towards Green Mountain, doesn't it?
Correct.
Yes, it does.
Fuck it, I'm dashing for it.
You running it? Oh, goody. Yep. Give me an athletics check. Make sure you burn a ration.
12 to 2 with my bonus.
Yeah, you make it.
Yep.
So...
Fuck you, motherfuckers. Grey. I yell, thanks, Phil, as I sprint off into the distance.
Who's all this right, Phil guy?
Yes.
Well, thanks, Spider.
Handling with the vector.
It's got hit. It's got shot.
It just got shot in the arm, so you know helps here. So with the combat, you can go full offense. If you go full offense, I'll let you use your twitch and your tactic to break free from the vector and get out of its grab range. But that will deny you the ability to resist it if it attacks you again this turn. Or you may spend your tactic to continue resisting it and try and hurt it. You could attack it. I believe you have a bayonet on your rifle.
I do have a bayonet.
Fix bayonets.
You try and I'll say narratively it's cool. You can try and hook your rifle up under it and get a stab into it.
I'm gonna stab its head.
Are you calling your shot?
Yes.
Okay, that means you cannot spend extra abilities and you need to succeed.
Mm-hmm.
All right, give me a roll.
Come on, Grey.
Please. Yes!
What?
6/5. It's not enough to kill it.
Nope, that's 6 killing to its head. Yeah, it's you stab it through its head. It's still
mouth.
Begging you in Russian to kill it. It kind of
I'm
whimpers
doing
at
it, you.
You
bastard.
It says, "Think of." She says, "Think of my daughters. I ate them. Please.
Oh God.
I'm
oh
going
God.
To burn in hell. Please.
Well, we're trying to
kill
send
me."
You there.
And she bites at you again. It's her turn.
I'm glad I can't hit this.
Yeah, you guys can. You're all ghoul netted in.
Well, can't we just turn him off?
No.
Can't we just turn him off?
Yeah, fucking kids, man. Oh my god.
Well, I don't want to say
Alex
that, I've got bigger problem.
This is what you
yeah,
get for running to a bush.
Yeah, yeah, Gray. So that'll be 7 killing to your leg.
Fucking hell. Did
two.
Fall over or something?
Yeah, 7-2.
Must have fallen over or something.
Which
stage,
leg?
Gray.
Two. Leg two. One and two. Zone 1 and 2. It's your left leg.
Thank you.
Is that the one you're already hurting? Or no,
no.
You healed it, didn't you? Smart yeah. boy. Yeah, that's good.
It was my other leg the last time.
Gray.
Is it a dry bite?
Yes.
Give me a resistance check.
Oh, shit.
No. I do it. I succeed.
Okay. All right. So we're not gonna do a resistance check on you. It just scraped at you.
Okay. Thank God for that.
It's got a boot on. It's got a boot, so it just like kicked you and almost broke your leg.
Yeah.
All right. So that was the vector's turn. Jim.
Jim.
I have to run over to my hawk.
Okay. Give
I have
me
to
an
go
check.
Check it. I have
she
to go check it
rations.
Out. I just like fucking sprint over there.
Okay.
Like, if I can burn extra rations to run faster, I'll do
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. You can.
Yeah, I'm gonna burn a ration just to run faster.
Okay, so that's +1 on top of your athletics.
Well, I'll still fail. 8-10.
He misses you, though.
Nice.
Okay, that's good.
Do
right. I make it over there? I just thought, oh no.
No, you didn't make it over there.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, you're kind of
scrambling.
Stumbling, fumbling, bumbling, rumbling, blumbling.
Sure.
All right, back to the top of the order. Ripley.
Yes.
Still big
I'm
vector.
Going to shoot at the vector again.
Okay.
So I mark
the
off
shot.
The charge, yes?
Yes. Would you
head.
Like you could do a called shot and shoot it in the head. You may not add any extra bonuses to your roll though. You just have
okay.
to succeed.
Okay. I'm gonna yeah. call it to the head.
Okay. So okay. Phil. Yeah. LS is running. He's booking it. Phil. Towards the tree line.
Can I follow him but like slightly behind him in stealth? Or is that cover
no.
long gone now?
I mean, yeah, you can do stealth, but it's going to take you the same 2 turns to get
yep. private. Yeah, that's fine. That's
so
fine.
You're going to fall behind. All right,
yep.
stealth test.
So that is 7-1.
Okay, yeah, you're fine. Log shots. You made it to the tree line. Jim just took off out into the open field. See Phil's slowly, methodically moving his way up behind you. What do you want to do?
I have a rough pause, don't I, on the...
Yeah!
Tracker.
Yeah,
I want to stealth check this, because I got an axe.
Okay. Give me a stealth check.
Into 3.
So we're back to me, then.
Yeah, it's back to you.
I'm just doing the same thing. I'm putting the second knife in this thing's head.
Alright. Yeah, so called shot puts you at the end of the order if you're going to try again.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to go. Oh, fuck. Come back, Black Dice. I didn't mean what I said. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's really unfortunate for you, Gray. Greg, give me a resistance check.
Oh, dear.
Give me a resistance check. You don't want to fail.
I've already failed. But I want to use that will point.
Good.
Good shout, man. Good fucking shout. I was like,
otherwise,
shit.
Your head would be over there. That's 11 killing to the head.
You'd be decapitated.
That's 11 killing to the head.
Oh, my head would be over there. That's my favorite thing I've ever heard.
All right, so, yeah, it didn't take your head off, but you're concussed. You're on the ground now. You're in a bad day. Jim, what are you doing?
I'm running over to my bird, man.
Okay.
He's making a second attempt.
Yep, second attempt. Go.
I just about pass.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. What was it?
Oh, the fucking.
It was a. It was a 6/5.
Okay. Yeah, you get to it. So yeah, you can scoop it. You can scoop him up.
Can I first aid him?
Do you have first aid?
Yeah, I have first aid.
Give him.
Jim has first aid. That's awesome. What didn't even know he had first aid.
Give the bird CPR.
I'm very squeamish. Normally I wouldn't do it. But it's the bird. Oh, I just about pass again, like 6/5 again.
6/5? I thought that is passing.
That is, he's just passing.
Brits say it differently than we do.
Yeah. Oh, okay. And we say just about, it's like just over whatever.
Yeah, for us,
see, we mean we didn't quite make it.
No, oh, sorry.
It's all good. When you explained it the first time we went through this, I picked up on what you're laying down. But yeah, no, it's completely opposite.
Ours just means it's close.
No, you do stabilize it. It's not going to die.
Oh, thank fuck.
You can't
use
the rest of the mission, though.
That's okay.
Put it in your bag or something.
Yeah, it goes in the bag.
Put it in your bag with this
god. I tenderly put my fallen comrade in my bag.
You're up.
Your turn.
Okay.
He's so fragile.
I just rolled. Now, I add or I don't add?
You get to add your shoot and that's it.
Okay. 11/1.
Frickin' hell, an ice rip.
Beast.
Head just shatters. And goes.
I saved your butt again.
He's dying. He's
dying.
You need to go make a med check right now, Ripley. Right now.
Yeah, you're the only one there.
You're the only one there.
9/2.
You're freaking angel there, Gray. Angel just.
Fucking Guardian Ripley.
One shots.
So is he not dead now?
He's not dead. He's stable.
Okay.
Is my head still on killing?
Yeah. It is.
She's just stopped you from dying.
She stabilized you. You're not dead. Log shots. You see the fucker?
Okay. Good. With the axe. Okay.
Yours is maxed out, isn't it?
No, but I've got sturdy and I've got sling.
Okay.
And quick for it, at least.
I can quick draw, it buys off cumbersome, and
okay,
I'm
well,
also
yeah, you already,
buying
yeah.
off wear and tear for it as well.
Okay, that's cool. It does do killing damage, so go for it.
It was 8/3.
Nice.
Okay. You chop him in the leg real good. Down he goes. How do I want to play that? Yeah, he's not unconscious. We'll do that. I'll be nice.
He's not unconscious.
Is that yeah.
So can I interrogate?
Hold on. You just chopped him in the leg, so wait a second.
You just chopped him in the leg. Yeah, he just fell on the ground. So he's still very much in this.
I nearly got shot from someone lying on the ground.
Yeah, everybody else give me athletics checks to get to LS's position. Like right now.
I assume not me.
8/3.
Okay. Gray, what are we doing with you?
9/8. On mine, just to give you a shout.
Okay, yeah, Gray, it's all... Yeah, it does turn to stun, not killing. So...
Oh.
You are unconscious, though.
Thank God.
All right.
I'm unconscious.
You are unconscious.
Get me an EpiPen.
So, Phil, you made yours, yeah?
Yep, 9/8.
Jim?
I succeeded.
Okay, so yeah, you guys all get there. This guy's got a rifle. He's swinging around like mad. Do you guys want to restrain him and take him alive, or?
No.
No.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Jim's being...
Ripley's absolute savage.
I don't trust anybody anymore.
I don't.
Just take him alive.
You want to take him alive? Alright, I need some resistance checks to kind of get him under control.
Well, that...
From everybody?
Give me like two. Give me two.
Okay.
8/4.
Okay. Yeah.
4/5.
Alright. Jim is not helpful. Anybody else want to get in there on this?
9/2.
Okay, yeah. LS jumps on it too. Alright, yeah, you guys get him under control. He's barely understandable, like he's like hissing and like wheezing at you guys. It's mine, my mountain. My mountain, go away.
Golem,
go away.
There's Golem.
Or help's coming. I have lots of help coming. Go away.
Oh God. Somebody shoot him, he's rambling.
I wonder where
speaking in tongues.
Yes. Should we just fucking shoot this guy?
Can I fuck the shooting? I don't want to alert everybody in the surrounding area, but our chopper's
I've got an axe.
Yeah, I've got an axe as well.
He's giving me the heebie jeebies. I think we can all agree heebie jeebies are being
I want to kill him. He's a threat to Green Mountain. Hint.
We need to find out.
Take a will point, Phil. Kill him.
Yes.
We need to find out more.
I'm killing him. I'm chopping his head off.
Use the power of arterial blood to use him as a jetpack.
Yeah, Phil kills him. You don't need to make a roll. He's tied. You guys tie him up.
I just literally take his head off.
Oh my God.
Yeah, you just take his head off.
What do you do to him?
I just get my axe and fucking just decapitate him, like execute.
Oh my God! In one fell swoop.
Can we
as well.
Use his head as a trophy?
If you want.
No.
In a zombie apocalypse, really?
This is not the start of The Witcher 3, Adam.
Don't
cut off the griffin head.
Someone give me a scavenge.
Rip.
What?
Scavenge. Go scavenge.
Okay, scavenging. What do I need to scavenge? Just roll.
Yeah.
Well, I should probably not say this because it's bad against the party, but shouldn't she stick with Gray considering he's passed out?
Well, she charged over. She came
yeah,
over.
Yeah, she's already left me.
So Gray's just passed out on the street.
He's passed out over there.
He's blacked out over there.
I stabilized him.
Fair enough.
Somebody's going to get there.
I can't complain. She saved me, but I will complain in a few minutes.
When a casualty walks up and eats you.
Am I with the group now?
All right, so what am I doing? Am I going back to help him?
Oh.
Yeah, everybody but Gray is standing over the dead body of the asshole you just killed.
I'm going to burn a UB specs thing.
Okay.
So that I can get the +2 to scavenge.
Okay.
So
is that it?
So who's scavenging here? I thought it was only one of us. I thought Rip was scavenging because she's got skills.
Yeah, Rip is a scavenger.
I'm going to scavenge too. I got skills.
Are you allowed to scavenge too? Talk to the GM.
Only one person can scavenge.
Why not?
So if Jim wants to do it,
all right,
take it.
No. I don't. Ripley, you do it. So okay.
Rip.
Oh, okay.
I'm over it.
I'm rolling. You're over it. 7/7. Does that mean I lost?
Fail.
No.
That's a fail.
Yep. That's a fail.
Was that with your bonus?
That's with my bonus.
Yeah.
We really should have let the guy with scavenging and the Uber Specs bonus
to scavenging.
So yeah,
in the tussle, you guys broke
the rifle. Did he have scavenging? I didn't
know he had scavenging. And his ghillie suit is obviously messed up from you guys chopping his head off.
Uh-oh.
So yeah, you don't find any identification on him or anything.
Right, guys,
else to tell you anything
can
about.
I roll awareness? I want to roll awareness to see if I notice anything in the woods.
All right, awareness.
Awareness check. Come on, 11/4.
Okay, what were you looking for?
Just any more movement or any like? Has he got friends out in the woods? Is
nah,
no,
nah.
It's quiet.
Of course, it's quiet. You see a boar running by.
Okay.
Yeah, there's really nothing scary about this place. So yeah, you guys get LS to go pack up Gray and haul him back to Starry for medical attention.
What?
The rest of you, well, you're unconscious, aren't you?
Yeah, you're out, mate. You're lucky you're not dead.
You are very lucky.
Use an EpiPen.
Nope, don't have any. So yeah, that leaves Phil Ripley and Huate to go up the mountain to go secure Green Mountain.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
Can we go stealth? Can we go quiet?
Please.
Yeah, we're going stealth.
All right, give me stealth checks. You're taking Gray back to Starry. Yep.
Oh,
get
God.
It patched up.
11/5.
Okay.
4/4, crit success.
Nice.
All
so
right.
We all succeed until gets a crit.
Bill, you hear them.
Them.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, one of them is screaming about their kids.
Vectors.
Is talking about... the curse of the Americans, and one of them, that sounds like a grocery list.
So I make the others obviously aware that there's vectors here, but really super quietly, whisper.
Yeah.
Sounds like three-ish.
Yeah, sounds like three.
We've had at least five vectors here. Jesus Christ.
Three distinct forces. That four. You fought one. There's three in there.
No, but there was
possibly.
The one in the town.
Well, there's the one in the town, but he wasn't.
Yeah, but that wasn't a part.
Yeah, but we've still come across them.
Yeah.
Well, again, you guys are only a year into the Blight, so vectors are going to be more
common. He did say that there's
going to
be a lot
markets.
More vectors around. So I was like, possible 3+ vectors to the others. And sneak up to the wall, I guess.
All right. Well, you see inside the courtyard, nothing's really moving around. There is an ATV off in a corner. And that's really genuinely just about it, honestly.
Can I sneak up and put my hand on the ATV to see if it's warm?
Sure. Give me a check.
What am I rolling for that? Awareness?
Stealth again. Yeah, stealth again. Stealth.
Okay, that's another crit success.
Oh my god.
10
to 10.
Okay.
Okay, what
yeah,
the hell?
So you get to the ATV. It's not warm at
okay,
all.
So it's locked in.
But it has a hunting rifle in the gun rack. And in the back, you find bounty.
Oh, oh shit.
I'm still...
6 bounty.
Yeah, 6 yeah. bounty. Okay, add 6 to my bounty. I don't like this. I like
yeah.
to know shit. And where are these fucking vectors?
Well, they're
about.
Inside. The top.
So,
you hear like voices echoing.
I was
going
to say,
so.
Are they inside?
Over to the office building.
Which
okay.
building do they sound like they're in? Can we tell?
Somebody gives me an awareness check, maybe.
I've got an idea.
Jim?
One of us should jump on this ATV and drive like a madman and draw all the vectors away.
Is that what you want to try and do?
I don't
yeah,
think that's
hunt,
a good idea. Let me shout why. There's only 3 of us. You're already split in the party, dude.
Yeah, but if I'm drawing away all the aggro, that's fine. I can go do a lap of Green Mountain.
If you fuck up, then you've got 3 vectors on you and it's just you.
Got grenade launcher.
It's up to you, man. I'm just telling you the warning.
Are you going for it, Jim?
I think I'm going to go for it. Yeah, I'm going to go for it.
Okay.
Can I... Wait. Before he goes...
Uh-huh.
Can I climb up the tower and get on the thing with the railing up there to
nope,
overwatch
locked.
Him in case he
doors
does
locked.
Have trouble?
Doors locked.
Or shoot at them because I have a
No, because
rifle?
As soon as you start shooting at them, that's just going to make them turn around and completely
I
fail.
Did say the
I
locked.
Have a stealth sniper rifle.
It doesn't work that way with those things. And for the third time, the door is locked.
So you
can't
get into
not
the tower.
I missed
tower.
That was locked.
Yeah,
okay.
that's
fair.
You
that's
should
fair.
Not get the tower.
Okay, Jim, I'm going to pat him on the shoulder. Nice knowing you, mate.
All right, Jim, give
so
me a drive check
wait,
to see if it'll fire
just
up.
One last
or
question.
Mechanics.
You're saying
what?
It doesn't work that way. So when you shoot at them, it just makes them mad and they come after you? Is that
yeah,
what
no.
Get...
The suppressor does not generate new zombies. So in a firefight, you're supposed to roll for more noises, which I didn't actually do in that last fight because it got a little hectic. But traditionally, weapons that are loud
well,
generate
I don't think
more
we
zombies.
Used any loud... Oh, we used a
grenade launcher.
Yeah. Whoops.
So, when you use loud weapons, it generates extra zombies for you to deal with.
Right, but wait,
it does
okay,
not
so the silent
affect
sniper...
cognitive
It doesn't
creatures.
Stop them.
Now,
so, yeah.
personally, I think narratively it's more fun, so that's why I let, you know, when you guys fail checks, to let guys get away with making pot shots at you with suppressed rifles, but technically, by the rules, it doesn't have to work that way. So, what Phil is saying is correct. You opening fire on the vectors isn't going to
it just
is going to draw attention from them. They are still cognitively active to a certain extent.
They're filled with a bullet hitting their back or something.
Yeah, they'll know that somebody shot them. And they'll respond to it in kind.
So if this plan's going to work, we've pretty much got to let Jim go. We'll let Huate
yeah.
roll and hope for the fucking best.
But I'll let Phil give me one more awareness check.
Okay. Awareness check. So yep. that's 12 over 7.
The tower.
The voices are echoing
out of
fucking
the tower.
Protects. The tower fucking protects.
Yeah, except it doesn't. The voices are echoing out of the tower.
It does.
And the tower
it's
door is
locked. Great rolls.
So yeah. Driving off in the ATV is not going to do anything.
No, because
so
it's okay. Got Jim. Hello. 2-8. They're in the tower. Don't turn that engine on. You're just going to piss them off.
Oh, okay. All right. I go back into stealth mode.
Right. Stealth mode activated.
So,
my semi reduces.
Green Mountain Tower. How do you want to deal with this?
I think we want to lock ourselves inside and go explore it.
Yeah, that would be. Not the tower.
Yeah, they're in the tower. You don't
yeah, we don't
want to
go
right,
in the tower.
We want to go
we'll
check
clear
out
the other buildings out.
Yeah,
yeah.
we want to
okay.
clear the other buildings.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure, go clear the other buildings.
But we're stealthing through them.
Of course
yeah.
we are. So we're rolling
stealth
now.
I'm just making
now.
Sure that the GM knows
yeah,
what
no,
we're planning
I appreciate
to do.
It. Give me a stealth checks.
So that is 9
Ooh,
to
critical
8.
Success.
9 to 8.
I got a crit success.
Okay.
So
with a crit success.
Well, what did Jim roll because
Jay,
he's laughing?
Jay, you
okay.
might want to hear.
What happened?
Might want to hear what I got. I got a crit fail.
Okay.
You got a will
point. How do I want to play?
What happens if one person crit fails and one person crit succeeds?
We're about to find out.
it gets really interesting, and I get to play narratively with some ideas.
Oh, that's cool. That's exciting, then.
The crit success is... Oh, fuck, I don't want to do this. With your stealth test, Ripley, you actually discovered... Oh... Fuck it. There's a war pig in the compound.
Oh, yes!
Boom.
That is the British Land Rover with the Russian grenade launcher on it for some weird reason.
Oh my god.
Just a random question for...
Yeah?
How the universe works. Grenade launchers in Green Mountain, will they destroy buildings?
No, these are... Cool. I'm going to treat these like actual 40mm grenades. No, nice. They're cool. Not going to.
Sweet.
You don't need to worry about that. Yeah. Jim stepped on a tripwire, the door swings open on the mountain.
On the tower.
Give me initiative. Power? Give me initiative. I'm rolling for the Zeds. Alright.
So that is a...
Oh.
What am I doing?
Alright.
Rolling your initiative dice, black die.
It's black dice plus your speed.
5.
11.
I'm throwing a fuck.
Wait, you're the one who chased the tripper.
Yeah, you're still, like, panicking. You're like, what the fuck?
Alright. So, Phil and Ripley, y'all go first?
Yep.
There's three vectors. Yeah. The lead one is a businessman.
Yep.
And he is cursing American arrogance. The second one is an older woman, and she's crying about her grandchildren. The third one is, he's kind of a weirdo. He's wearing, like, one of those Russian fur hats, you know?
Yeah.
Like, nobody actually wears that shit anymore, right?
No.
And he's, and well, he's rattling on about for some reason. He's still rattling off a list of items.
Okay. What were the items? Anything interesting or just crap?
You want to? Is that? Do you want to spend your tactic on that?
No. I was just
generally
wondering.
If you do, I'll give you something for it. But
no.
That's
no, I
do it.
I've got to fucking do shit. I'm about to. You're about to. If we don't act quickly, we're all dead. Just to give you a heads up on this, how serious you will be when you're dead.
All right.
Well, I have body armor on, so.
It's a vector. Yeah, vectors will tear you to shreds.
Stop.
That doesn't work that way. It's great against bullets.
So I want to run to the war pig and jump on the front gun.
Okay.
The machine gun, because I will blow up Jim.
You want to get on the machine gun? Okay. Yeah. You can do that. Give me an athletics check.
So that's 7-6. No, 8-6.
All right, yeah, you make it into the truck. Ripley, what do you do?
There's only one gun on there, right?
But you need to have a turret. Can I use the machine gun?
Yeah. With the turret skill, you can use any turret. Yeah.
Okay, cool. But there's also something else, Rip, in the truck.
What?
There's several seats in the truck.
The driver's seat?
Oh, I can drive.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm running. The driver's seat.
Give an athletics check.
So
make sure you guys are burning your rations.
9. So 9/4.
Okay. Yeah, you make it to the truck.
Okay.
Yeah. So. Yeah, the vectors are just going to close, all three of them.
On QA.
You guys. How I'm seeing this, you guys know the courtyard. It's kind of like the almost kidney bean shape, right?
Uh-huh.
You know, you guys went to the building. The war pig was parked on the north side of the building, right?
Yep.
Okay.
So Jim is still by the door to the big office building. And you guys ran to the war pig, and the vectors are pouring out of the Green Mountain Tower. Jim!
Yes.
You're up.
Fuck up.
I
need an athletics
run?
Check, no?
I think so. Make sure you burn your
You're
ashes.
You're pretty athletic.
So my athletics is +2.
Yep.
Come on, Carnival.
You can burn more rations to make sure you pass.
But wait, I've already rolled and I didn't do that, and I wish I had. Because I got 4-4.
You want to spend your will point?
Yes, please.
Okay. So what does it make it now if you flip it?
Well, it's 4-4, technically.
6-2.
6-2.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that sounds right. Okay. Yeah, you make it to the gun too.
All right.
Back to the top of the order with Ripley and Phil. So, yeah, what do you guys want to do? You want to sit there and just try and gun them down?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. What do you want to do, Rip?
I'm firing the truck up so we got mobility.
Okay.
Smart woman.
Yeah, no.
Give me a drive test.
Yep.
Drive test.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Critical failure.
It doesn't start.
It won't start.
you like drive into a wall. You accidentally put it in reverse and drive into a wall.
Oh, gosh. How mean do I want to be? That's brilliant. Oh, that's good. Oh, gosh. That's too good. There's too many good, juicy things to do. Yeah, I'll give you guys a chance. You back up and smash the thing into the wall. It's fucked. The guns still work, though.
So, I'm rolling?
Yeah, you're rolling. Shoot. Shoot good.
That is... Well, that's terrible. I've only got wood. So, that's a 5-2.
That's unfortunate. Yeah. Yeah, you do 5 killing. You can spend more killing. You can spend more charges on the gun. The gun has 20 charges.
Yes. Yes, I wanted to do that.
You can spend more charges for more damage. So, yeah, you can blow its leg off.
Yeah, that's cool.
Which vector was that one? 1, 2, or 3?
1.
Okay. All right. So 1.
10 kill to the left leg.
So is that down now? Is he like crawling?
Nah. I mean, like, yeah, you blew his leg off, so it slowed him down. So he's not moving as fast, but yeah, it's a vector.
Yeah, he's still.
He kind of fell over, and now he's kind of crawling like a tripod.
Yeah, that's cool.
And it's his turn, so yeah, he's coming. But yeah, he will only move one leg that turn. The other two go next, and they're still moving at 2 legs per shout. So yeah, they're closing fast. They will be in melee range next turn.
Shit.
Jim. So here's how we're gonna do grenade launchers. We'll let you have it do something. I'll give you spread. We'll call it spread. Okay.
So, on my grenade launcher.
Yep. So
on the grenade.
You can spend your twitch to deal additional damage to an adjacent target. So yeah, you could target vectors 2 and 3 with this if you want. But
okay, yeah.
You're gonna be stuck in the truck.
Well, that's what I want to do. That's fine.
Okay. Yeah, give me a shoot. The grenade launcher also has 20 charges. So go ahead and give me... How many charges are you burning to hit these things?
Oh, man. I mean, I want to make sure I hit it, don't I? What do you think is a good solid, like... Okay, man. I want to fucking hit this hard. I want to spend, like, an extra, like, 4 charges to make sure I get it.
Great.
Make
5.
Do I just use it?
Make 5.
Is it a normal shooting check?
Yeah, it's just normal shooting check. Plus 5.
Right. Crit success.
Boom! Get out of the fucking way.
All right. Yeah. What kind of crit success? What was the number you hit it?
Oh, it's 4. It was 4-4.
Bits.
Yeah, that's enough. That's enough. you absolutely rinse the 2.
Nicely done, man.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
So, yeah, back to the top of the order. Yeah, you've got one more vector crawling at you with a leg blown off.
Or unload on him again. 9-3 on the saw again.
Okay. So, yeah, you want to spend extra charges to blow that leg off?
Fucking hell.
You can spend one more charge and then blow his leg off.
Yeah, no, I understand what you're saying. Yes, I will.
Try and shoot him with a rifle, or should
yeah,
I?
Yeah, absolutely.
You can drop out and put a bullet in him.
So I got 10/6.
Okay. You blew its arm off. It's still pulling itself towards you.
With one arm. Okay.
Yeah.
I should have called my shot. Okay.
And it's talking about the awfulness of capitalism and the arrogance of the money pits of the West. But yeah,
it can
only move half a leg because it's just pulling itself along on one arm. Jim, you want to use the grenade launcher on the last vector?
Yeah, man, I'm going to fucking go for it. Why not?
His hawk's been killed. He's pissed off. He needs to kill something.
I need to fucking blow shit up.
Well, he's not dead, but it's been
he's been injured. He's been injured. My fucking baby.
Q8 is raging.
Oh yeah, I'll smash it like 11 over 5.
Okay.
Good job.
Yeah, that'll do it. With a grenade launcher, that'll definitely do it. Yeah, you toast it. Yeah, everybody give me self-control tests, because holy fuck.
This is crazy. Some crazy shit happening. I fail.
That'll be 2 to detachment.
There.
Sorry, stress. Sorry, that's stress.
9 to 5.
Oh, wait. I passed, barely. Okay.
Okay.
Because I had 2 in self-control.
Cool.
Alright, yeah. Yeah, no. Another day on the job.
Me and Rip have been out in the fucking shit.
Yeah.
We've seen vectors.
I've seen vectors before. It's no big deal.
Yeah.
Totally no big deal. You had it under control. You had this armored death monster.
I just hadn't hit the wrong gear.
Yeah, it was a bit of a slip of our hand. It happened.
Yeah. Alright, so yeah. Just need a mechanics check to get the tower up and running.
Oh.
So we're clear?
Can
we all clear?
Do that?
Are we definitely clear?
Are you clear? Are you clear?
Can I aware it?
Awareness?
Give me an awareness.
All of us?
Whoever wants to.
Phil's doing better than me. Go for it.
Well, we can do multiples. We can do multiple rolls, right. So might as well. If you can, always roll. The GM lets you do it. So that's a 12 to 4.
Okay.
Noise.
Yeah,
and mine is 6 to 2.
Okay. You hear something clinking?
Clinking.
Yeah,
metal.
like metal on metal. Like rustling
like
in
the
wind.
The guy wires or something is loose and banging.
Possibly. Is that what you think it is?
I think that's what it is.
I don't believe that.
You want to go
investigate
it?
I think it's going to be something more horrendous than
yeah.
that.
Yeah, where is it coming from?
It's coming from inside the tower.
It wouldn't be a guy wire. Okay.
Well, it could be. The guy wires are up there.
Yeah, but they're not
inside.
In it.
Oh, okay.
All right, you going to go check it out?
I want to not hit the door, make a little bit of noise.
Okay. Yeah, bang, bang, bang.
Yeah, with the
nothing.
Axe.
Nothing. Yeah,
no
you
response.
Just keep
clinking. Nothing.
Just the clinking.
It doesn't get more.
Just the clinking.
Clinky.
Just the clinking.
Doesn't speed it up. Doesn't.
No.
Okay.
Slow down. Okay.
Just the clinking.
So stealth on in then, I guess.
Okay.
I'll go first because this is my kind of close combat kind of shit. So that is a 8-2-4.
Yeah, you see it, Phil, and you know what it is.
Self-control test.
Yeah.
Every time I see something, it's self-control test. It's never like something nice. Fucking apocalypse.
Nice, you know what? It is something nice, Phil. It's an Egyptian tattoo.
What?
It means meek.
Oh fucking hell! Okay.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah.
And my self-control is a 5 to 1.
Okay.
So this tattoo, is it on a person?
No, it's a metal like.
Oh, it's like
it's like a piece of metal that's hanging from a chain over the hallway in the hallway.
Okay.
Where the vectors were all kept.
Oh shit.
Oh god.
Almost like a blessing. Need a mechanics check to get the radio tower up and running.
Whoa.
Are any of those mechanics?
No, stop. Stop that thought at the moment.
Easy, Phil.
Yeah, but everybody's doing stuff and I'm like, my character's like, no, stop!
Who the fuck am I, Meek?
Oh
yeah,
my god, okay, great. Go for it, mate.
Right, I'm just going to play it. Research while I'm lying in the hospital bed then.
Yeah, that's fine.
From what I know, they are literally the epitome of all hatred.
Well, that sounds nice.
They kind of believe the blight is a gift from God, if I'm correct.
Oh.
And their sole intention is to make the blight just spread as quickly as possible.
Great.
Yeah. Oh, awesome.
Our kind of people.
A very sick-minded group of people.
Yeah.
Whatever you gotta do in there, do it quickly and get the fuck out.
Not gonna happen. I wanna go and jump on the machine gun. No, the grenade launcher. And sit there.
Okay. Be my guest.
And sit there and do
Jim,
nothing
I believe you have mechanics, right? You wanna hook up the antenna?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Alright, give me a check.
Yeah, pass.
Cool. Yeah, it hooks up. Gunslinger pings you, and he's like, yeah, reading it 5x5. Good job, people. Here's your money. Bing, shows up. He's like, where's your shooter at? I'm not seeing him on GPS.
He's all right, don't worry.
He didn't buy it, did he?
No. He's all good. He's good.
He just turned his Ubix specs off again. Great.
No, yeah, I'm here.
And I log off. Or Gunslinger logs off.
God damn it.
He's too slow. All right, so how much bounty did we get for that again?
Do you want to give me a scavenge check and see if you can find anything else in here?
Yeah, I want a scavenge. Oh. I can scavenge.
Checks. Everybody can give me scavenger checks.
Yeah, I'll pass scavenger.
Okay. So nothing's happened and no one turns up.
To one.
Sorry.
Scavenger.
Hold on, Rip. Give Phil a chance to talk.
Sorry, so we've just radioed through. Gunslinger's good job. Here's your job.
Yeah.
No response from anybody. No one turns up. Nothing happens.
How long are you sitting there waiting?
Probably a
Not
day.
Fucking long.
Probably a day.
That'll be next week.
Rabbits. You see some rabbits go by, but that boar is still out there.
I am waiting them for who? Them to come back.
Them who? Spygon.
Huh?
Them who?
Oh, that certain group.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do they ever come back, or do?
But there's no group. There's no nobody comes back.
Okay.
You find a small living space. Looks like just one person. Lot of weird writing.
Can we read it, or is it in like Russian or so?
Yeah, you could read it.
What does it say?
It's a bit of plays on like the meek shall inherit the earth. You know, that kind of shit. Like definitely some derivatives of Christianity and probably Byzantine, like orthodoxy in particular.
Okay, so I get
twisted to such a point that it doesn't even have relevance. I mean, they're using an Egyptian symbol for meek, not any Christian symbols. It's not a symbol of a lion, which is traditionally associated with kind of Christianity's like double play on the meek.
I'm gonna roll now, right?
Yeah, be my guest.
Okay. And I got a crit success.
Freaking out, Rip.
What kind of crit success, Ripley?
Here comes
the money.
That's
not great, but not it great. Was still critical.
It's a critical success. Well, I didn't realize they were ranked.
I will give you all two sets of polymer tipped rounds. These are for rifles, so it will be an upgrade to people with rifles may have them.
Who wants them? Because I haven't got a rifle.
I have a rifle. Do they shoot
you can take
the
them back for me.
Ripley,
you just, for all intents and purposes, it's a rifle. You can call it whatever you want, which I assume it's a suppressed M110.
Yes.
But like, as far as the game is concerned, it's a rifle. That's
okay.
It.
Okay, so two sets of what?
They are polymer-tipped rounds, so they give a +1 to damage and also a +1 to upkeep on the rifle because they're rare.
Okay, so I need to add one to my upkeep.
Mm-hmm,
I want one of them. Can I have one of them? And somebody else can have
one
of them?
Yeah, you may have one of them. There's two sets.
Okay.
And then with a crit success, I'll also give you a chainsaw.
Holy shit.
With
nice.
An electric
Don't give that
motor.
The long shots. There'll be no trees left.
Yep, it has an electric motor, so it's not loud.
Nice.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's
pretty cool.
Wait, I'm getting
a
+1 on what? My shooting?
Damage, not your shooting, your damage of the actual weapon. So the weapon does kill damage equal to your 8 that you roll. Now it gives you another +1 to that. So it'll be your black dice +1 is how much damage it will do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it's pretty cool.
Okay.
But it's more expensive, obviously.
So with the door of the tower springing open with the trap, is that door now workable or is it fucked?
Sure, yeah. You can totally make it work now.
Okay, cool.
Pretty general, basic thing.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Jim, I believe you had a scavenge check. What was it?
Mine was a pass, but not by much. It was like a 6/4.
6/4?
Yeah.
I'll give you 6 bounty.
Nice.
Yeah.
I'm going to roleplay that I'm too on edge with my surroundings at the moment to do a scavenge check. I do not like being surrounded by all this symbolism.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. But there it is. There's Green Mountain.
All right.
Congrats.
How much
Phil,
did we
you
get?
Can mark
how
off your war goal.
Did we get
yes. Boom.
How
the
much
bounty,
bounty
you guys
we
have
got?
Found.
Yeah. Oh, I got 6.
Oh, yeah, 6. Yeah. It was 6
That's
in the
it.
Truck.
The 6.
Yeah.
Okay. ATV too.
Yeah, we got the ATV.
We got the six out of the
ATV and the hunting rifle.
I got the six out of the ATV. Yeah.
Okay, so that's 12. So you got 12. You could scavenge the truck though, the war pig.
Can we get it back up and running, or is it super fucked?
It's
I got a 9.3 on the
warpig. Yeah, I'll give you 8 bounty for the weaponry on it and the ammunition. You can sell that. You can hawk that at Sorry.
Okay.
So yeah, there's another 8 bounty for you guys. I'm a nice GM. And I believe that's 2 war goals satisfied too, because you have a hunting rifle.
Yeah, I wanted a big ass hunting rifle.
Yeah, this isn't a regular rifle. This is a new thing for the new upgraded weapons list. This is from that. So this thing is a big fuck off Magnum hunting rifle.
Oh, so he's got a new rifle. Sweet.
Yeah, awesome hunting rifles. So that's man.
Well, is that polymer tip runs forever or are they left there?
20,
as long as you play your upkeep.
Oh, okay. I thought they were only 20.
Nice. So is this an upgrade on the rifle then?
So yeah, Jim has got 2 war goals done.
Obviously, I need to get rid of all this meat stuff. So like,
taken Green Mountain, you still need to actually secure it though. So
yeah,
I'll say you're halfway home on your war goal.
Yeah, no, I was thinking that was a bit like, yeah, I should like.
You spend 10 bounty and you'll get enough.
Well, I've got 10 bounty in my pocket. Da-ding.
All right.
Boom.
Let me divide up bounty amongst you guys really quick, just so you can have that written down, Ripley. So.
Okay.
So you guys, where's my negotiator sheet? So you guys got 24 plus, so that's 36, 44 bounty split 5 ways. That will be one person will get 8 bounty, the others will get 9. So who gets the 8?
I'll take 8 because I ran away. I was
just kidding. Nice to
see you. Thank you, Rat. You guys got 9 bounty plus the Ubik specs. If you want to hawk them or keep them and actually utilize them.
No, I think that'd be helpful at some point.
Keep them, yeah.
Yeah. Like how many times like not being able to communicate with half the team is needed.
Okay.
You've also started Gunslinger's. You've built a relationship with Gunslinger. You have his job line open now if he ever comes back around.
Was it 9G for everyone else? Sorry,
Yep, 9 bounty for everybody else. So,
I'm the man with a lot of questions at the moment because of
it's fine
the situation.
Yeah.
So me throwing that 10 bounty down. So is Green Mountain like fortified now?
Not yet. It will be in 3 turns. So 3 games. You'll have 3 games locked out. 3 games. Yep.
Okay.
You need to hire somebody to come in and do some work on it.
That's going to be
Or
hard.
You can do it yourself in your free time.
Yeah, I'm going to do it myself.
Okay, if you do it in your free time, that's going to cost you it's going to cost you from either your personal time with your loved ones or from being able to do job hunt stuff. So,
okay.
You'll have to pick every game we play.
Also, because I don't want the guy coming in, can I have a point? Because I don't trust people messing with Gallifrey.
Sure.
Yes.
Well, I already gave you one. I already gave you one for that. So yeah.
Did
only I? For. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you already did that one.
I got one for the Meek thing, didn't I?
You got one for the Meek, and I thought I gave you one for Gallifrey stance. If I didn't, yes, take one. Yeah, you can't.
Yeah,
milk that twice.
No, I know that. That's why I was like, I don't think I've done that because of.
Hey, Jay, was all that bounty, by the way? Was that including all the stuff we looted and whatever?
That's
everything
split.
Everything.
Your breakpoint is taken care of because you guys did get that paid for, so don't need to worry about that. But you guys might be a little light this one. I know you guys' upkeep's getting up there a little bit.
But
so.
We have a base, man.